Please pray for our brother here who just accepted the Messiah, denounced the devil, and he believed that the Messiah is his savior. Put him in your prayer, him and his family. Pray for his safety, pray for his guidance, pray for his wisdom. Pray that the Lord will provide him to so he might go and come to a church or somewhere where he can do baptism to himself. All right. So thank you, my friend, for calling us. Do you want to say anything else before you leave?
I just want to say thank you and keep up the good work.
Thank you, my friend. May the Lord bless you and thank you for calling. Take care.
God bless you too.
God bless you too. Bye bye. All right. We are happy for this brother here. God is good. And God do not leave himself without witnesses. Okay, we have an ex-Muslim. Skype is like a reception, tons of text, and it's hard to follow up. As you see, this religion is nothing but nothing. Garbage. It's empty.
Hello there.
Hey, my friend, how are you? Oh, we lost you.
Hello there.
All right. Do you hear me now?
Yeah, I do now. Just the connection keep cutting off. I don't know why.
What do you like to share with us, my friend here? Your life on air.
Following your channel for a while now. It's quite nice, fun to chat with. I'm out of the religion, Islam. About.
That's wonderful. When you left Islam?
After a while, looking at the Quran and the verses, the hadith, with a different, actually, with a objective, perspective, life is quite good and fun to see. And it's good to see what you've been going through.
All right. And when you decide to leave Islam, how long ago?
6-7 months now.
6 months?
Yeah, 6-7 months ago. And that's it. And it took a while, of course. A year of searching, reading.
What make you like and come to the conclusion that Islam is
false? In the religion in Islam, yeah, I'm from Turkey.
All right.
Yeah, in Turkey, Turkey is not really a very strict religious country. Depends on the area where you live. And my family was average religious, like basic things. Ramadan and the other daily prayers on Friday and stuff, we were doing it. Mm. But on the other hand, yeah, you have friends around you, keep recommending you, you have to do it, you have to do your praise 5 times a day, you have to do that, you have to do that, you will go to heaven. And then you always have a part inside you which you feel bad because you're not doing it. And eventually you say, I will do it one day, I will sit and do everything properly. But I wanted to check what's the religion, what the book looked like. I didn't want to do all the Arabic praise that I didn't know the meaning of, just because I feel good about it. Like when one Fatiha and I feel good in the graveyard or something, they feel like they're being purified or something. I don't want to feel like that with some birth that I don't know even the meaning. So I sit and I read and read and read and read. In time, of course, first it starts with small suspicion, then you say no. I'm sure there's a way that we're convinced that you start watching all videos on Medidat or Zakinling, blah, blah. But after a while, you say, fucking hell, why do you have to always convince myself? And you just throw it away. That's what happened, how it happened with me.
All right. Well, yeah. You know, always, yeah, let's say, let us try to find to forget about the way we used to talk and the language we used when we were Muslims. And yeah. Did you accept the Messiah as your savior or not yet?
Oh, no. I'm out of the trauma. It takes a while. I want to enjoy my free mind. I want to look at the world a little bit without any kind of God belief for a while.
Okay.
Look at the world. All right. But I was a tour guide. Of course, I studied Christian. I studied Judaism a little bit in Turkey. So your customers are from the other religion. So you have to know about it. So I know about Christian quite a bit as well, but not, of course.
You see, I like the way you think. But you see, me as a Christian, I have a free mind too. I mean, who said that I'm not free by believing in Jesus? My friend, you're wrong.
I respect all the what you say. I live in Holland, actually. My wife is Dutch.
All right.
I got married about 4 months ago, and I'm now living in Holland. I like the way of how people think. Even you have here the atheist channels, you have these channels, you have this channel. Nobody called them and start swearing at them or threatening with life or something. In Turkey, we had atheist professors or speech givers. When they were coming to universities, they were coming with 5-6 bodyguards and police outside. They had to go with a security, securing those people's life. So I just, okay, you're Arabic. I just wonder, actually, my main question is, where is this aggression coming from? Why so much aggressive? Even if we're not Arab, that through the religion, also it passes the Turkish people. You cannot talk about religion. You talk about two ayats, and the third one, people start getting aggressive. Close it. Don't talk about it. Who you are to judge the God or prophet? Why is this aggression?
Yeah, because Islam is aggressive cult. You know, Islam, the only way this cult can survive is using aggression. It's not by talking and debating and let us see who is right and who's wrong. The only way is aggression, so they will silence you.
Yeah, all I see it are seeking for truth and trying to make comments of the ayat stress, the historical facts, all you hear about and under the video in Turkey, all over swear, threatening, swearing at their kids, wives, babies in the prom. They go crazy. It's really crazy.
Yeah, you know, actually, my book, which is about Quran and science, is made actually to refute a guy who his name is Harun Yahya. You know him, I think, Adnan Oktar.
Yeah, I know.
Who made from a big project about Quran and science. He is the one who started all this garbage. And I made my books to refute all his lies, and I get him busted. And right now, actually, he's in jail, right?
Yeah, he's perfectly in jail, and all his beautiful cats, pussies, they call them.
All his beautiful hookers.
Yeah, the makeup, without makeup, they don't look as pretty as they look on the TV. To be honest, they look like horrible.
I don't know. He's the same as his prophet anyway. For me, anytime you wish you want to know about Christ, about Christianity, I would be happy to talk to you. I understand that you don't want to now. You don't. Maybe it's not right time for you to talk about it. But anytime you feel like you have a questions, you want to ask me, I will be happy to help you to accept the Messiah or to know about him. And for sure, it's up to you to accept or not to accept.
Thanks to our today's world, see Christian. You know the technology, computer, YouTube, the books. As you said, you can straight away download it and you have it in your hand in a couple of seconds. It's not really difficult. I think if it's meant to happen, if it's really meant to show you the path, probably that you will have the inspiration and you can go and check yourself. You don't need always someone to tell you about religion, maybe.
You see, sometime, like, you know, let us say, you know, if you have a problem with your eye, you go to an eye doctor, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Not because he have different eyes, he have eyes like you, but let us say he have more specialty, so he have better deep study. So nothing wrong with me helping you. Doesn't mean that you are a fool and I am smart. No, it's me who spend a lot more time than you about what I believe, and I can help you to give you a shortcut for answers. Maybe will take you long to find the answer for them. Now, okay. I want to ask you, did my videos help you to leave Islam, or you found your own?
No, see, to be honest, I was just about 2 weeks after I left. I left it. Mm. I saw one of your debate with Eddie Buxell, you know, the guy, the chubby guy, lives in USA.
Okay.
The Turkish guy. It was quite fun and really good to watch him. He's the irrational 19.
Yeah,
or
he's a 19 scam. Yeah,
without that 19, I was also had a talk with him. I said, without 19 miracle, that how you call without it, probably you would leave Islam straight away. That's what his whole team, I think.
Yeah,
kind of. I also met him and talked to him a little bit also. And when I was looking at his videos, and I saw the UCP, and I saw also you talking to the guy, the Turkish guy living in USA. His name is Redvan, I think. I'm not sure. They just was a couple of days ago.
You know, I talk to a lot of people, and for me, it's really hard to remember. You know,
yeah, I mean? I know you do. He has also a YouTube channel. He says the Apostate Prophet is the channel name.
Prophet. Okay, yeah. He's a Turkish.
He's also Turkish. He's from Gaziantep, in a city of Turkey, right. Quite a religious area, blah. And I listened to his story, what he's gone through as well. So that's how I saw you, and it's quite fun to watch it.
Yeah.
And it's enjoyable to see. Sometimes, you know, when you debate with also people from your own country, from the Islam religion, it's really annoying after a while. You cannot make them accept the fact, but the way you make it, you do it, and you put them down and make them see the truth, and they just get angry. I like to see it, and that's fun, to be honest. It's like a show, watching a show.
You're a person who likes to watch a fight, I can tell.
No, it is like a little bit relief feeling, you know. It's like kind of revenge what I've been through, my thought, how the pressure in my mind, even fucking hell, I just leave the legend 6 months, still kind of sees those shaitani or genie things still. I'm under impression, affection of it. I cannot just get rid of it, and it's just pissed me off.
Yeah. I have an advice for you. For sure, you're a person who don't believe in Christianity or any religion, but try not to use the F word. I know that people, they use it a lot, but try to not to use it, because it doesn't make a speech better, you know what I mean? I mean, I know that some people, they use it because people use it. But the effort does not make our point better. There's no point for it. Anyway, my friend, I'm really happy for you that you left Islam.
Thanks for your time.
If you have any question in the future for me, you want to call me, feel free. I will be happy to help you. If you have any question about Christianity, I will be happy to help you with that. Thank you very much for calling.
Thanks, man.
Take care.
Enjoy success. Yeah, bye.
And by the way, don't forget to invite your friends from Turkey so they can join us, and we can, you know, help to, you know, like help more people to leave, and that will be for the best of the country which you are coming from. So, as you see, you know, people are leaving Islam left and right, and using a threat and using you know, harsh language and threatening the person to stay, not to leave, etc. We're not making a difference. People are leaving. People are leaving by a mass number. The internet, it might be in the beginning, it was like the Muslim trying to use it to fool many, and they were able to fool many actually. But the internet is hitting back. Because all those who the Muslims, even they converted them to Islam, sooner or later they will find that the Muslim did lie to them, and they will leave, and then they will become enemy number one to Islam. So for me, I believe strongly that you being a Muslim, convert, is more dangerous to Islam from a person like me, because you will go in, you will see how stupid it is, and then you will come back as an ex-Muslim exposing this cult, the same as what happened to the guy who was 16 years Muslim, his name convert to Islam, and now he changed his name. Don't convert to Islam. You know? Hello. Yes, my friend, go ahead. We hear you. You're live on air.
All right. Yeah. There was a time I called you, and calling, taking the line. There is an echo on the line.
Well, you are fine for me. Go ahead. What do you want to say?
Okay.
Are you a Muslim?
I'm an ex.
Oh, you're an ex-Muslim. Okay. Well, wonderful. Yeah. Today we are just ex-Muslim. So you are from where, my friend, if you don't mind to say?
Well, I'm from West Africa.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
All right.
But I spoke to you before. There was a time I spoke to you before.
Okay. It's hard for me to remember. I apologize.
Oh, no problem. I just saw the title of your show today, and I decided to call because I wanted to contribute to this particular issue.
All right.
The Boko Haram issue, because I am part of their culture, and I know what it is. I speak the language. So I think we are Hausa. The Hausa is a native in Nigeria that is in West Africa that is really incorporated in Islam. And it is such that Hausa be able to convince Hausa and Hausa from coming out of Islam is going to be very difficult, because it's like Islam is in their DNA. They will not understand, because it's over thousands of years now that they are practicing Islam in Nigeria. So you receive the call.
We hear you. Go ahead. Oh, we lost you. There's a guy, he keep calling me. I mean, don't you see that somebody is talking? If you know that somebody is talking to me live on air, why you keep calling? Let us see what it is.
Hello?
Yes.
No.
Mute YouTube, please. Mute YouTube.
I've muted. Yeah.
All right.
Hello.
Yes, I hear you. How I can help you, my friend?
Yeah, I'm calling from Nigeria. My name is Latif. I'm a Muslim.
Oh, all right. How are you, Latif?
Yeah, I'm fine. And you?
That's good. So what do you want to say to us, Mr. Latif?
Yeah, I was listening to your videos for so long.
Okay.
And I even, I'm from Nigeria anyway.
All right.
So I had you speaking with one lecturer then, Stas Jamiu Adigunwa, which I love watching his video very well.
Okay.
And I love watching your videos. But there's something that is not clear about or your argument. So now, some people who are saying they accepted, I'm a Muslim, I've told you. Mm-hmm. Some people said they have been accepting Islam, Christianity, turning from Islam to Christianity.
Okay.
But what is baffling me is this. Which church would they be going? That is number one. Number two, my second question is, which church does Jesus go when he was alive? Was he just a Christian? Can you please explain to us? I still have so many questions and some issues I want to address about the Christian, about Quran that I've been talking to. And please, I want to beg you, stop abusing Allah. When you abuse their Allah,
let us talk with one topic at a time, please, if you don't mind. Is that okay?
Okay. Yeah.
First of all, which church you go to is not important for any church. Speaking of the Lord, is his a church? So the church, when you say to me that if well, Jesus is a Christian, that's funny of you. Because Christianity is a person who is following Christ, not Christ following himself. So to say, was Jesus a Christian, that is not a smart of you to say. It's like saying to me, was God a Christian? That's really funny. He is a Christ. So we are Christian because of him. We are called a Christian. Secondly, when we say a church, what a church should go to, it doesn't matter really. You believe in the Messiah. The Messiah, he did not say, you believe in this church or that a church, whoever believe in me and die will live. So what we need to consist to be consistent with is following the teaching of the Messiah and to believe in him. So we believe in him. We don't believe in bishop. We don't believe in priest. We don't believe in a church name. We don't believe in a sign. And then as long as you are the one who mentioned this, isn't it your prophet? He said that my nation will be 73 sect and one of them only will go to heaven. So based on your logic, hold on, my friend, let me answer.
Okay.
You are the one who said it to me. Let us speak.
You have said so many things. Please let me contribute.
No, I will let me finish first. My Lord, he did not say my followers will be 73 sect and one of them will go to heaven only. It is your prophet who said my people will be 73 sect and only one of them, which is a small minority, will go to heaven. So now I'm asking you the same question you gave me. Which sect you should go out of the 73 sect will guarantee you to go to heaven? Go ahead.
Okay, now I want to go back from where you stopped. I will start from the 73. You see, we have so many sheikh in Islam. Hello, are you with me?
I am with you.
Have you ever read the book of Ibn Kathir?
I'm learning. I just heard
of it. I'm a reader. Mm-hmm. I'm a reader and I studied books and I read differences. Mm-hmm. Now, when we talk about hadith, we have Sahih Hadith, we have Dahih, Now,
why
Quran
have,
says
why
Quran,
you have sahih,
wait,
why you
hello,
have
hello,
sahih
let me talk.
Why you have sahih
let, let me talk this.
Okay, why you have sahih
talk,
and daif? Why you have sahih
let
and
me talk. Let me talk.
I'm
please.
Letting you talk.
Please
why
let
you have sahih
respond.
And daif? I'm asking you why you have sahih and daif. What's wrong with your religion? Are you saying to me my religion does
not
have a good base?
Hello, let me talk now. You have spoken. I've given you a lot of time to talk. Let me talk. Let
okay,
people hear what I'm,
ahead,
what
go
I'm
ahead,
saying.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
And here now,
okay.
When we say Da'if, I will tell you the reason why we have Da'if.
Uh-huh.
I will also tell you,
mm-hmm.
When Muhammad was alive, hadith was not written down.
Okay.
That is why an average Muslims will rely on the Quran than the hadith. Now, you talked about Quran, hadith, the prophet said hadith, the sect will be prorated to 73. I want to tell you that according to Ibn Kathir and so many other sheikh, that hadith is a fabricated hadith. Quran has never said so. In Quran chapter 3 verse 85, Allah says, whoever accepts any other religion as that but being a Muslim, that will never be accepted of him. And at the end of the day, the person will be a loser. The meaning is that if you are a Christian, a Jew, anything you believe and you didn't accept Islam, you are going to hell. In Quran chapter 3 verse 19, Allah says, in the deen or in the law of Islam, there's never anything that talks about what we are talking about.
Okay, let me make it simple. Hold on. So all your speech
don't
is based on what? Hold on. All your speech, please. All your speech is based on that the hadith I gave you is weak. Is that correct? You are saying the hadith I gave you, is it weak or strong? The hadith I gave
it is weak.
Okay, if I show you it is sahih, what you will do?
That is what, please let me talk now.
No, if
now,
I show you that this is sahih, no, you are just wasting my time because you claim
I'm
that this is weak. It's a lie. It's a lie. Why you are lying? Here we go. I have it in the screen
hello,
in front of
hello,
me.
Hello,
it says,
hello,
it says,
hello.
It says sahih.
Hold on.
Why you are lying? Why you are lying? Does it say in the front of you in the screen? Does it say in the screen? Listen, I don't respect you. I don't respect you. No, you are a liar. You said this is weak. It's in the front of
you.
It's in the front of you. It says sahih. How do you say your prophet is a liar?
No, you have mistakenly picked my phone, and this will be a problem on you.
My
this
friend,
is a big problem.
Why you are avoiding the problem
the
now? Listen, you talk too
it's
much. You say nothing.
It is a big problem on you.
Does it say sahih? Hold on. I want you to prove me wrong. I want you to prove me wrong. Stop talking. Stop talking.
If you curse me, God will punish you.
No, your God will punish you.
You will definitely punish you.
Your God cannot punish me. He's a fake God. Don't change the topic. Coward. Stop it. Changing the topic. The hadith is sahih.
If people are
you're idiot.
Christianity from you,
does it say sahih? Look at
this
idiot.
This is a false.
Shut up, you idiot. It's in the front of you. It says sahih. You see how they avoid the tribe they built for themselves? Which one I will follow? Are you going to read the hadith or not?
I am, hello.
Are you going to read the hadith? It says sahih and you are a liar. Yes or no?
Please, why do you cut me in the
front? My friend, because
this,
you keep talking, you don't allow me to talk.
Have me.
We have to have a conversation. You keep talking. I'm asking you. The hadith
hello,
in front
hello.
Of you.
Okay, let's do it this way.
The
let's
hadith,
do
the hadith
do
is on
me?
The screen.
I have hadith with me here.
Shut up.
From me?
No, I don't respect you. You're a liar.
Support.
Why you say it's weak? Why you say it
myself.
Is weak? Shut up. Shut up. Idiot. I'm going to go and shout until tomorrow. You are listening to me. Don't call me until you see the hadith. Don't call me. Give me a text in the sky first. Says I saw the hadith on the screen, and it says sahih. Are you going to read
hello?
It or not? Does it say sahih?
Oh yeah. Let me see.
Okay.
Bring your proof.
Okay, it's in front of you. It's in the screen. It is in the screen. Stop talking.
Okay.
Read it.
Hello. Don't tell me to stop talking. I'm not your mate.
Well, you are. You are because I am screaming for the last 20 minutes asking you to read it. You keep saying to me, show me the proof. Show me the proof. Show me the proof. Shut up. Read it. Shut up and read it. Shut up and read it.
I am not. This is what
stop.
Taught you. Stop. So Christian taught you to abuse me.
You are a coward. Yes, I abuse you. Why not? You are a donkey. You are a certified donkey. Prove it to me that you are not a donkey. You said to me, show me. I'm showing it on the screen for those 20 minutes asking you, please read it. Are you going to read the hadith or not? Are you going to read the hadith or not?
I have read your hadith. I've okay. read what you put there.
Okay, is it sahih? Is it sahih or not? Is it sahih or not?
Huh? It is not sahih. What make it sahih?
Then shut up. Tell me what make it then sahih. Shut up. Get lost. Don't talk. Don't call me. It is not sahih. This is your Muslim saying it is sahih, your donkey. Don't call me. I have no time for kids. No, don't call me. I will not talk to you. No. You are a coward. You are a potato. It is not me who is saying this is sahih. This is your Muslim website. This is sunnah.com. And this is authentic book, you idiot. So the only game they play with us, it is not sahih. Anything we say to them, which is making Muhammad look like a donkey, right away they say to us, it is not sahih. Play with this game with someone else. I am here to get you busted. A bunch of cowards. You are an insult to your prophet. You are saying now that your prophet is a liar. This is why you are in denial. You cannot believe that your prophet, he said something stupid like this. Hello?
Question, friends.
Yes.
Hi, I was just listening to you. And the guy was telling that I'm not your maid. And you don't tell me shut up. I'm sorry. I'm just replying to him, not talking to you, okay? So it's like he came to your channel. You have all the rights to tell him, shut up, because he's not listening, okay? It's not about being made. It's not about being something. It's like he came to discuss with you. You can tell him, shut up, because you are talking.
You don't want to let me talk? You don't want me to hear. Believe me,
Christian friends. I mean, like, I sometimes, when I'm watching your videos, I sometimes feel I watch on phone. I my laptop is gone. I mean, it's motherboard. Okay. Sometimes I feel like I'll throw my phone on the wall. I don't even, sometimes I feel like, you know, you should keep patience. Okay, let them talk. But sometimes I'm like, you know, I want to throw my phone on the wall because you are talking with them for like 30 minutes and they're not answering anything. They're like on the same thing. They'll be repeating. And you're asking a simple question. They can reply. It is written there or not. And they will not answer.
Yeah, he wouldn't read. And even after we show it to them, he said, no, it is weak. I mean, look, I mean, who is the one saying it's sahih? It's in front of him.
I'm watching that. Seriously, I'm telling you, I wanted to throw my phone on the wall. Seriously, yeah. Thank God he disconnected or you disconnected. Seriously, my phone is saved because of you. And thank you for that.
We can show the hadith in many places, by the way. It says sahih in many places, not only in one place. So when they try to deny, simply because he got hurt, he is the one who mentioned to me which sect we will follow, correct? And now I just showed him that Islam is divided even more than Christianity, because according to his prophet, Christianity is divided to 72 sects, Islam divided to 73.
Yeah, exactly. God, seriously, sometimes I really thought I will tell you that, Christian friends, please be a little bit patient, because more they talk, they'll do more poo-poo. Your words, okay? More they talk, they'll do more poo-poo. But if I keep listening you or keep listening him, you know, I want to throw my phone on the wall because they are not answering.
Seriously, I appreciate your patience. Worry. I always force them. They can play games with me. And if you want to play, just a donkey, I just, you know, get him out. Who care? You know?
But seriously, I appreciate your patience. And no, seriously, you have a lot of patience. Seriously, I'm telling, because repeating every day, same thing with same Muslims, I mean, like, you know, Muslims, same thing is really frustrating. I'm sorry, I'm taking you a lot of time, but I want to, I want to talk with you on Trinity. I just want to keep my thoughts with you. If you, I just want to know that if I'm right or not.
All right.
Okay. Right. See, most of the Muslim, they want to speak about Trinity, and the Bible says about Trinity that he made us in his image and his likeness.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he made us also in the same way. So if I ask a Muslim, do you believe in a soul? He will say, yes, I believe in a soul. Do you believe in a body? So he'll say, yes, I believe in a body. then if we ask them how you see us, if I'm speaking to you, am I speaking to your body or am I speaking to your soul? What do you think? What will he answer?
First of all, my friend, always when you debate Muslims, don't debate them by your own logic. Debate them by their own logic. Their prophet, he said,
he quoted
exactly what the Bible says. Muhammad, he said that Allah, he created Adam in his image. Read with me carefully. And this is Sahih Hadith. Allah created Adam in his image. Let's read the Sahih Bukhari. Allah created Adam in his image. This is exactly
They say that it's his Adam's image. Yes. They say in man's image.
Allah, he created Adam in his image. This is the image of Allah. Read carefully. Yeah. You see, it says his and big with big H. You see his?
Yeah.
Big H. Why is big H?
I cannot. Because this is. I'm sorry.
Because this is about the law.
I'll watch your video later.
No problem. But Muhammad himself, he copied that from the Old Testament and he put it in the Quran.
Correct.
Muhammad was at that time trying to make himself a Jew. And actually, Muhammad, he took Shahada to be a Jew. If you remember the hadith where Muhammad, he said, he took the Torah and he put his hand on it and he says, I swear by thee. I believe in thee and the one who sent thee. That was a Shahada. Muhammad is trying to prove to the Jews he is a Jew.
Yeah,
Muhammad is copying from the Jews that Allah, or that is God, he created Adam in his image, but he had his own fiction, which is that Adam was 30 meters, which is very funny. So when the Muslims speak about the Trinity, first of all, if their God himself cannot understand the Trinity, so how do I expect the Muslim to know about the Trinity? We need first to ask them why your God could not learn what the Trinity is about, because according to the Quran, the Trinity is Mary and Jesus and Allah.
Correct.
So what is the Trinity?
That is funny because nobody believes it.
That's true. So here we find that the God of Islam, he did not even mention anything about the Trinity which we believe in.
Correct.
And remember, the Muslims, even in their debate, they say that in the first three centuries, not a single Christian believe in the Trinity, which is a lie, because all our fathers actually, who is the father of the churches? Isn't it those who wrote the Bible for us? So how you say in the first three centuries, nobody believe in it? Isn't it John from the father of the churches? Isn't it Paul from the father of churches? Isn't it Luke? Is it Mark? So this is a lie. And we can search right now in the internet and we find long list of names of the father of the of churches in the early Christianity who taught the Trinity everywhere. And not only that, you are from India, right?
I know you by my language, the way I speak.
You will find, I love Indian people, by the way. And I feel sorry sometimes. I don't want the Indian to be upset because I make fun of the Zakir Naik, but because he's funny, I'm not making fun of
him. No, he is. Yeah. I'm a Christian, but and he is funny, really.
There's a church in India, a very ancient church, by apostle. His name is Thomas. So Apostle Thomas went all the way to India, right? And he established a church. Okay, let us say the Roman, the first Trinity, as they claim, or after the 300 years of Christ. What about the Ethiopian church, which is not a Roman church? What about the Indian church? What about the Persian churches? Those are not under the Roman. So how in the world this has happened? Even Arabia itself was not under the Roman. The Roman never occupy Arabia. The Roman never occupy Mecca. They never occupy all this territory. This is a big fact. It's stupid, actually. Christianity spread all over. Even the Muslims in their books, they speak that God, you know, when Jesus, he sent his apostles. This is what I like about Muslims. You know, Muslims, they copy Christian stories and then they add spices to the story. So according to the Muslims, that the apostle of Jesus, they came to Jesus. Jesus, he said to them, go and teach and preach. So the apostle, they said, how we can go but we don't speak the language of people around us? He said, don't worry, go sleep and tomorrow is different day, new day. They woke up in the morning, everybody speak different language. All right, and now Jesus sent his disciples to everyone. Now look at this. As long even you Muslims acknowledge that Jesus was able to make his disciple speak in many languages, while your prophet, he asked for seven Quran just to understand one language. And the same time, as long as they spoke many languages and this went to many nations, how you can corrupt the book?
Wow.
You know? So
this is all crap. I from the time I have started, believe me, from the time I have watched your videos, every day I try, even though it's like 1 a.m. for me, even though if I'm watching like 15 minutes of your live feed, but at 1 a.m. I watch your 15 minutes. After that, obviously, I have to sleep because I cannot control my sleep. You know that. But every day I watch your complete video, and those are like really wonderful. You like 4 hours video, 3 hours video. I appreciate your effort, Christian Prince. I am downloading your videos soon. I'll be putting them with subtitles in another channel, and I'll put all the links about your channel also. And I because a lot of Indians do not understand English, so you know, I'm thinking to put like audio for that. Yeah, if possible,
that would be good. Or even and, make a subtitle.
I'm serious. Yeah, subtitles will be better, because they will, if I put audio, they will think that even I'm speaking something of my own mind. Yeah. You know.
Well, thank you. Your
voice is must in that.
Yeah, thank you for
and Christian, I'm really sorry to consume your time so much. Last thing I want to tell, it is for Muslims that I mean, I will tell you, but obviously it's for Muslims that Christian Prince, why don't you ask them that you are not, don't use the word debate. You say that I want to discuss your religion with you, so that they will not try to jump in Bible.
No, I have
you
no
know,
problem.
Debate in the sense they can talk
you
about
see, my
Bible.
Friend, understand? No. Let me tell you. A Muslim, when he asks about the Bible, he shoot himself in the foot. I have my own way, and you know that. Here we go. The guy he just called.
Yeah,
right?
I know that. So I know that, exactly.
I don't want to put conditions. Just call me and say whatever you want. I will get you busted. I am a Christian prince. That's how it's work. You know.
I was just saying that if you tell them I want to discuss your religion with you, because they keep jumping on Bible and they don't want to answer.
No
problem. they just try to avoid the answers.
Yeah,
you know, and like for 1 hour, for like 30 minutes, they'll be eating your head, they'll be eating my head also. And thankfully I didn't break my phone. You know,
no, they cannot do that with me. So, as you see, when you speak with the Muslims, you have to be like you have to have a strong character, otherwise they would try to intimidate you, and they would try to speak over you, and then by speaking like crazy you know, truck, then okay, you shut up, and then they keep talking forever, saying nothing. I don't allow them to do that.
They will not say anything. No. They will never answer. They will keep repeating the same thing, even though you tell them 100 times. And I don't understand, when you're showing them from your book, from their book, from their Muslims written Islamic books, and they're calling you liar. I mean, like, if they're calling you liar and you're reading their book, it's like they're calling their books liar.
Yeah, and the funny, they say to me that this hadith is weak. Anything we say to them, it's weak. We show it in the screen, it's
weak.
It's
what
weak.
Some Muslims will tell that it's a straw, you know, they passed. You only told. I'm learning from you. You are my teacher, okay? I'm learning from you. You showed some Muslims are telling it's passed, you know, it's authentic, this and that. Some Muslims, they are not united in their own religion.
Yeah.
And they're saying that you are lying. How you are lying?
No,
I mean, like,
my friend,
if somebody is reading
some
from Bible, I can
call.
Explain.
My friend, I apologize.
Yeah,
for you.
Of course.
Some people are trying to call. So
I'm really happy to speak with you, and thank you very much for doing this work. Thank you.
Thank you.
God bless you. And thank you very much. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, my friend. God bless you. Don't try to play games with me. You are not qualified. And here we notice that the nation of Muhammad is the most divided one. And not only that, only little sect is the one who will go to heaven, which means the majority of Muslims go to hell. Not the Sunni, not the Shia, because the Sunni are not the minority and the Shia are not the minority. It has to be a small sect if Muhammad is saying the truth. If Muhammad is true prophet, there's a small tiny sect is the true Islam. The rest are false. Yesterday we were talking about gambling, right? Islam is nothing but gambling. Literally, a gambling. Okay. Someone have a question? Let us see.
Hello.
Yes, my friend. How I can help you?
Oh, hi, Christian Prince. I have a few questions, if you could help me with that, because I'm trying to show the proof to a Muslim I know. I wanted to know if the female genital mutilation is part of the Sunnah, because all Muslims say it's not, but I have read a hadith where the Prophet tells a woman to cut, but not to cut too much, the girls. And also, if there is a minimum age established by either Quran or Sunnah, and a girl can get married, because I watched one of your debates, and this Muslim guy was telling you he could actually marry a baby girl.
I lost you. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, okay.
If you could please answer those questions for me.
Yeah. Well, you know, the circumcision for both men and women, the Muslim they call it something is called fitra, which means it is something must happen for both. And the Muslims, they give an excuse that the circumcision for the women is to reduce her desire for sex, which will make her supposedly a better woman. This is why you see in all Islamic books, it says, like, when the circumcision touched the circumcision, talking about what? Talking about a man, circumcision, touching the private part, circumcision of the women. Then both they have to do what it's called a wash, all right? So circumcision is a must for both male and female in Islam. But the problem is that circumcision for women make women lose all her right to have a sexual pleasure, because that will destroy her sexuality. The Muslim, they say, well, you know, we should not cut all of it, we cut little of it. I mean, so what the point of cutting it anyway? You see, what is the point of this cutting this little thing? And that will, what a difference will make to God? And since when circumcision is about circumcision for women? You know, if you are trying to follow the Jews, they circumcise the man, not the women. So yeah, where do you get this from? Simply because Muhammad was trying to copy the Jews, and he do not understand, and he decide, and as long as Muhammad he decide, that's it. Who dare? Muhammad, he said, there are five acts which conform to pure nature: circumcision, removing pubic hair, and clipping the nails, and blocking the underarm hair and trimming the mustache. Here the Muslim, they say that this is goes for both male and female, not only for, even he is mentioning the mustache, but simply he is talking about circumcision for both. Mustache is for male. Now I find that circumcision is nothing but a crime against women, and it is a stupidity of Muhammad who made him believe that women she have to have circumcision. He was trying just to follow the steps of the Jews. And by the way, Muhammad himself never circumcised.
But was it like a cultural thing before?
No. This is Islam. As you see. No. This is Islam. This is not, have nothing to do with the culture of the Arab. This is Muhammad.
Okay. And it is Sunnah. Like, it is an obligation.
It is Sunnah, absolutely. It's a Sunnah, absolutely. Yeah, it's a Sunnah. This is why we are saying this, what Muhammad said. Muhammad, he said, you have to follow five things. And, you know, and one of them,
circumcision is part of it.
So there's no question about that, you know.
And all schools of thought agree with that.
Sure, they cannot disagree. If Muhammad says so, who dare to disagree? You know, if Muhammad is the one saying so, is not like a scholar saying so. Actually, let me see if I can find you a hadith where Muhammad he said that clearly.
Yeah, that would be great, because I could use that to show.
Because
they tell me.
Here we go. This is a hadith, and this is sahih, as you see. Here it says, a woman used to perform circumcision in Medina. The Prophet said to her, "Do not cut severely, as that better for women and more desirable for the husband." So Muhammad here is confirming that this is a woman. She do it as a profession, you know. She's a Muslim woman. She's do it a profession. And Muhammad is telling her how to do it. Don't cut severely, because the husband, he liked to have something there, you know.
Instead of your rebuking,
as you see, it says sahih. Do you see it says sahih? So the Muslim can't say
right now the screen, but I'll go to the video and look at it.
Anything else?
About the minimum age for a girl to marry? A Muslim man marry a little baby girl?
For sure, because there's no age in Islam, you know. You know, Muhammad, he married Aisha at the age of 6, right? But which is equal
Let me ask you, talking about this, Aisha didn't move to Muhammad's house until she was 9, right? Did she stay in her father's house from 6 to 9?
There's many stories, but obviously there's some reference speaking about Muhammad. He have her already, but he did not have intercourse with her until she is 9, which means he was molesting her. You know, and Muhammad, by the way, he, as an example, he asked for the hand of Umm Habiba when she was a baby. You know, let me see if I can find the reference, so Muslim will not say I'm making things up.
Because they get all shocked.
This is a book. It's called Majma'u Zawaid, written by Imam Al-Haythami, volume number 4, page number 376, and it says here. And I changed any Muslim to say I'm lying. All right. Muhammad, he went to visit Al-Abbas. And then he said, let us see where it says. Okay. Here we go. عن أم الفضل بنت الحارث أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رأى أم حبيبة بنت العباس وهي فوق الفطيم. فقال لأن بلغت بنية العباس هذه وأنا حي لا تزوجها. So Muhammad, he said, he saw a child. She is a baby, infant. So he said, when she is ready to marry her, I will marry her. She's a big child. She is an infant.
Yeah.
You know? So, and supposedly later she will become his wife. So, and Muhammad, he asked for Aisha to be his wife, and she is 6 years old. And there is a limit. There's no Muslim in the world can come and say there is a limit for marriage. There's a video of a guy, his name Mimi Hijab, and it's in YouTube, in his channel. He was saying, in Islam, we confirm that there is no limit of age. What is the limit is la dirar, which means if she can handle it, which means she can handle sex.
Yeah.
So it's not the age. So if you have, according to him, which he claimed now that supposedly he is a person who knows, if the child can handle the sex, then you go for it.
Mm-hmm.
As simple as that. It's not the age. Let us say there's a child, she is 1 year old, but she can handle sex, then you go for it.
And just one more question.
Before you change, and if you I have a debate with the Muslim guy. I don't know if you watch it in YouTube. I was showing him from the book. It's called Tahrir al-Wasila, where the Imam, he was saying, Al-Imam al-Khomeini was saying that it is halal to perform sexual relationship with a baby infant, but without intercourse.
I saw a video about that too.
Yeah.
There's this one guy, he's an ex-Muslim, he's called Masked Arab, and he has a video about it where he shows the schools of thought position about that. But, you know, this Muslim guy was telling me, no, that's a lie.
No, you can watch the debate between me and the Muslims, and we can show it right now. Actually, I can find the reference right now as we speak. Let me see. Hold on.
Because some countries have a limit age, but that's established by the country, not by the Sunnah or the.
No, this has come from the British and the. And the French occupation. When the French occupy and the British occupy, they force their own civil law on things. This has nothing to do with Islam. This is the book of Tahrir al-Wasila. Variant number two, page number 241. And here it says, and I change it in Muslim to say to me, I'm making things up. He says, a problem number two, or let us say question number 12. It is not allowed to have sexual intercourse with a wife unless she is 9 years. And then he says, but all the other joys as touch with desire and hugs and putting or fondling, putting the private part of the man between or tafkhid, between her legs and between her thigh, it is okay, even if she is an infant drinking milk.
Wow.
And this is the difference in front of us. So there's no limit. You can marry an infant, but you cannot have intercourse until she is nine, according to the book here. But before the nine, he can do molest the child until that age.
Yeah, that's very sick.
Yeah, this is
it. And my last question is, because I've heard people saying, you know, that when a Muslim rejects either one of the names of Allah, a verse of the Quran, or a Sahih Hadith, he becomes an unbeliever. Where's the base for that?
Because he rejects the teaching of Muhammad, because the Quran says, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. You know, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. So if you disobey, if Muhammad, he say that, and you reject to obey, you know, to obey what Muhammad said, because by rejecting the hadith, you reject what Muhammad said.
Yeah, right? But most Muslims reject half of Sahih al-Bukhari just because it's full of nonsense. Yeah,
because simply, that's it. They are not Muslims. According to Muhammad, they are not Muslims. They reject his orders, you know.
Well, I can use that too.
Yeah, but what the Muslims they do, simply, you know, like when you show them something, like the guy he just called me, if you remember a few minutes ago.
Yeah.
He is in trouble now. So what he can do, if he accepted, he was the one questioning about which Christian sect to follow, and now he, you know, he got himself busted. So now what we will do? The only way is to go in denial and say, oh, we don't believe in it, you know.
Yeah,
that's it.
That's what they do when they call you. They, oh, I don't believe in this, I don't believe in that.
You see,
I don't take
all
this.
The verses in front of us, all the verses in front of us in the Quran. You can watch the video later if you can't see it. All those verses saying that you have to obey Muhammad, all of them, tons of verses, not only one or two or three or four, tons of verses saying you have to obey Muhammad, endless. So if you don't obey the hadith, that means you are out of Islam. Very simple and very clear.
You became a kafir.
That's it. You became a kafir. Because if you don't do that, okay, here we go. Chapter 3, as an example, chapter 3, verse number 32. It says, say, obey Allah and His Messenger. But if they turn away, then indeed Allah does not like the kuffar. The word here they translated as disbelievers, this is kuffar. You know, so the second you disobey Muhammad and Allah or Allah, you are a kafir. That's it.
Okay. All right. Well, that's good to know, because they usually deny everything when they don't like what they see, even if it's sahih. And
work with me. I'm here to get them busted.
yeah. Well, that's a good way to get them busted. Telling them, okay, if you don't accept this, then you're out of Islam. Congratulations,
they knew.
Not Muslim.
Trust me. They knew. But the Muslims, they knew in the same time that Allah, He judged them by their intention, which means if he lie,
and with good intention,
protect Islam, so in his heart he will say, I know I accept the hadith, but to protect Islam I have to say I don't accept it. That is allowed in Islam. So they knew, you know. But if they mean it really, if they really mean it that they don't accept it, that's mean they are out of Islam.
All right, well, okay, that's very good information you just gave me. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you, my friend. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye.
All right. Well, I think let us see here. We have a person trying to call. All right. Well, I tried to call you. It doesn't work. Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello, I'm Shalom.
Can you mute Hello. YouTube, please? Can you mute YouTube?
Okay, yeah. Like I have, I've been watching your video, I have so many questions.
All right, are you a Muslim, my friend?
Yeah, I'm a Muslim.
Okay, what do you like to say to us?
Yeah, like you're giving people some statement which is not true about Islam.
Okay, so, what is not true? Like what? Give an example, I said which is not true.
Like someone called you the other time, if you can remember one guy, Latif, that you gave him a hadith, something like that, like, you were arguing about it. I'm not even for that. Anyway.
What is the hadith I gave him?
Like maybe 73, something, I just saw it.
And this is not true?
Is that?
What is your proof is not true?
No, I don't know much about
No, what didn't, you... Didn't I show in the screen that this is a true? I mean, I'm showing what I say. Here we go. It's in the front of you. Does it say that this is Sahih Hadith?
Hello?
Yeah. Does it say in the front of you in the screen that this is Sahih Hadith? So how you say this is not true?
Let me see the raise first.
Okay.
Okay, now I'm seeing it.
All right.
No? Yeah. He said, great Sahih Darussalam.
Okay.
I think you understand the word Darussalam about that.
My friend, Darussalam is the printing company. It's not, this is not a
Thank
prophet.
You,
okay. But this
Thank
is,
you. Thank you.
But the grade is Sahih. It's not Darussalam. This is the print of the book. Now, is that Sahih or not?
Yeah, to this, according to this thing. Sahih.
Okay. Now, do you have a proof that this hadith is not Sahih?
Hello?
Do you have a proof that this hadith is not Sahih?
Yeah, the guy quotes a Quran verse for you, which you ignored.
The guy what? He quote what?
Quran chapter 3 verse 85. Can you read, please? Can you put it on the screen?
My friend, chapter what?
3 verse 85.
It's chapter 3?
Verse 85.
Verse 85. Okay, here we go. Okay, read for us. What 85 saying? And what does have to do with my topic?
Yeah, I don't know who we're hugging about. That's why I said I'm not from that. I'm not even about that. My own is for the another question. I just go back to what the guy said. I'm telling you what the guy
why
said.
What are you saying to me? No, hold on. You said to me, go to chapter 3, verse number 85. What this chapter is about.
That is what the guy quotes for you. If anyone desire a religion
so
other than Islam.
Who cares? I mean, this is stupid. Who, you know, if anyone desire any religion other than Islam, is not accepted. But this is a lie. Because the Quran, in a different verse in the Quran, it says that those who they are Christians and those who they are Jews and those they are Sabi and they go to heaven. So how he say only those... Huh?
Your point. Let me see.
Oh, you are saying you do not know it?
No, I don't. I want to see what you're saying.
Okay,
I want to see what you're saying.
Chapter 2, verse number 62.
Okay.
It says, those who they are Sabian and those who they are Jews and those who they are Christians, they'll go to heaven.
Let me see. I'm waiting. Please let me read the Arabic text. I don't like this.
Do you know Arabic?
Yeah, I'm very well.
All right. Go ahead. Read it.
Let me see. It's not coming on my screen.
You see it now?
Yeah.
Okay, read it for us now, Rick.
النصارى الصابئين من عمل بالله ومن أخطأ ولا خف ولا رسول حي ولا حجر قدير دارودي فلا
So isn't this a contradiction? How one verse says that if you are not a Muslim, you will not go to heaven. Allah don't accept other religion except Islam. And then here it says, if you are a Christian, if you are a Jew, if you are a Sabian, you go to heaven. Are you there? Lord have mercy. Hello? Hello? Okay. Call me back when you, I don't know what happened. You don't have answer, I don't know. But this is a clear contradiction. Because the Jews are not the Islam, and the Christians are not Islam, and Sabian are not Islam. All right, my friend. So what is your answer? Don't you see the contradiction here? How one verse says Allah accept only Islam as a religion, and then he accept the Christian and the Jews and the Sabians to go to heaven?
Yeah, please, please. I want you to understand this. I love you. I love you with something. Look at what ended it. Indeed, those who believe. I want to tell you the English now. I love this thing you brought now. I said the other one says Quran chapter 3 verse 85 says anybody that desire any other religion aside from Islam will never be accepted of you. Now the question is, what is Islam? What is Islam?
What is Islam?
Thank you. According to Quran chapter 2 verse 208, can we read that? Quran chapter 2 verse 208. We are still coming back to this. I want
chapter
to explain something.
2 verse
here.
What? Verse what?
208.
208. Okay. You're the one who called me yesterday, right? And your voice was cutting off.
No, I didn't call you yesterday.
Okay. 208. Hold on. Okay. This is 208. Okay. And
yeah, with you.
And
208. He hasn't come to my screen.
Read for us as long as you know the verse. You know, do not need to wait for it.
Yeah. That's it's coming. This is 205. It's coming. I don't want to see, because Allah said anybody that says something contrary to what is in the Quran will be punished. So I don't want to be punished.
Okay.
Or you believe. Enter into Islam completely and perfectly, and do not follow the footsteps of Satan. Indeed, he is too clear an enemy. Do you understand that anybody who enters into Islam is a Muslim? Do you understand that is Muslim? Now let's go back to that 2 verse 62. Let me explain that to you.
Explain it to us. Go ahead.
Now that it says among the Christians, it is not all the Christians now. Among the Christians.
It doesn't say among. Show me the word among.
Yeah, let's
you
finish.
Said you speak
Let me finish.
Arabic. You said you speak Arabic. I like you to show me the word among. And if you show it to me, I'm going to shave my mustache.
Quran chapter 2. Let's go back to it. I want to explain. It is Arabic. I love the Arabic than
okay,
the English.
My friend, don't waste my time. I know Arabic. You do not know Arabic. You know nothing about Arabic. Now show me the word from those some of them. They are the one who believe. Some of them. Show me the word some.
The number one is this. It says, and look at it very well.
But Allah, look at it. You see, here we go. You are in the corner. I want you to show me where it says that some of the Christians he's talking about. I want you to show me where it says some of the Christians. Go ahead, show me.
Now, why are you talking like this? Let me talk to you. It says in the Ladina. Are you with me?
Yeah.
What Ladina? Nosoro.
What? Okay.
Wasabihin.
Okay.
Wasabihin. Out of all these people you have mentioned, did you?
Where is the sum? You told me this is about sum. No. Hold on. Where is the word sum? Where it says that some of them.
That's what I want to tell you. Man, hello, man, billahi. Anybody that believes, you understand, in Allah and the day of judgment. Do you understand? Voila. Do you understand what I'm saying now?
Listen, Abdul.
Do you understand?
I don't like kids talk. Where it says some, it says those who are Jews and those who they are Christian and those who they are Sabi and those who believe in Allah and those who believe in the judgment day and those who do righteousness, they will go to heaven, all of them. This is what it says. My friend, no. Okay, hold on. According to your Quran, the Jews, they believe in Allah, right?
No.
What are you talking about?
Quran chapter 2, verse 1.
According to the Quran, the Jews are not believers in Allah.
Read Quran chapter 2, verse 1.
I'm asking you, hold on. Are you saying to me the Quran confirmed that the Jews don't believe in Allah?
I want to talk to you. Please, can you?
I am asking you, I want you to give me a confirmed answer, and then you can give me the reference. Are you saying clearly that the Jews don't believe in God? His name is Allah. Hold on, listen. I don't like kids talk. We are adult. So I want you to confirm to me. I'm asking you certain questions. I want a certain answer. Are you saying to me, according to Islam, according to the Quran, the Jews and the Christian don't believe in Allah?
Yeah, they didn't. They didn't believe in Allah.
Okay, let me show you. Hold on. So you are saying to me that your Quran is a corrupt book. Because the Quran says that even the Christian believe that Jesus himself is Allah.
Hello, see the statement you just said. You just make an insulting statement to me. Why would you say my Quran is, have I ever abused your Bible? Why would you tell my Quran that it's a corrupt book?
Don't change the topic. How you say to me, the Quran, you are the one who said the Quran does not teach that the Christians and the Jews believe in Allah. But yet your Quran saying, don't play games. But your Quran says that the Christian believe that the Messiah, he is Allah himself. How you say to me they don't believe in Allah, and everybody heard you, and I ask you repeat the question 4 times, and you confirm.
I want to give you proof now. I want to give you proof.
Answer me. The person in front of you. It says those who believe لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم, they are kuffar. Does it say that?
Thank you very much. Mm. This is a good point. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَالْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ. She understand that anybody that says, look at the translation, you can understand that anybody that believes, look at it, it's a kafar. That the Christians now, they are kafar. That is according to this ayah. That anybody that says that Jesus, Son of Mary, is God. This is the interpretation. You see?
No, it doesn't say that. It doesn't say that. It says those who believe in that the Messiah is Allah. I asked you, do the Christian believe in Allah according to the Quran? You said no.
Yeah, if you believe that Christian Jesus is Allah,
my friend, this is another question. I asked you,
a good belief?
Do the Christian believe according to the Quran that they believe in Allah?
You said no.
Listen. There's no real Allah. Don't play games now. There's no real Allah. There's no fake Allah. Did I ask you, do you believe in the fake Allah or Allah? No. I asked you, according to the Quran, do the Christians and the Jews believe in a God? His name is Allah. You said no.
I said they did not believe in Allah. Christian doesn't believe in Allah.
So why is the Quran saying that the Messiah is Allah?
The Quran says that the Christians, it's because you are reading this. Let's go back to Arabic. Leave the English. See what the Arabic is saying.
Do you know Arabic reading?
I'm reading something.
Do you know Arabic? Hold on. If I show you the interpretation for this verse in Arabic, are you willing to read it?
Give me now. Okay. Is it not here before? It's here before it was.
I'm asking you. If I give you interpretation for the verse in Arabic, are you willing to read it?
Hello? Are you ready to read it? Hold on. Stop talking.
You know, you people are crazy. You talk too much. I'm asking you. If I give you the interpretation,
is this what Bible tells you?
This is what the Bible teaches me to expose liars like you. I'm asking you, do you speak Arabic? Shut up. Do you speak Arabic? Yes or no? Say yes.
You said?
Do you speak Arabic?
Yeah.
Okay. If I show you the interpretation for this verse in Arabic, are you willing to read it and translate?
Yeah, now let's go.
Okay, and you will accept it.
I will interpret. If you give me wrong interpretation, I will let you know. What are you saying? Or what is the meaning of that? I go to Arabic school. I know what I'm saying. Do you know anything about Islam? You don't know anything.
Listen, okay. Let us see. I'm saying to you, if I show it to you, do you accept it? Yes or no?
Let's go.
Okay, hold on. Let's go. Okay, let's go. Everybody will laugh in a second. All right.
Everybody will laugh.
Chapter 5, verse number 17. Yeah, everybody will laugh in a second. Hold on. Which interpretation would you like me to show you?
Yeah.
Which one?
I'm waiting.
Go ahead.
This is Dela Line.
This is not a Dela Line.
This is what?
Do you want a Dela Line? I will show you a Dela Line. It's up to you. What do you want? You said you know how to read Arabic. Read. I'm waiting for you.
Yeah, come down.
Read. Start reading. What are you doing?
No.
Read for me, read.
I'm waiting.
It's in the screen. Show me. Read for me. Go ahead.
Yeah, you said, I read for us.
Yeah, read the interpretation. You said you know Arabic.
Hello. Are you with me?
Here we go. I hear you, my friend. You hear me very well. Come on.
Now, I said. Hello. You said you want to read for me, that you're going to interpret for me. I said, let's go. We are here. We are reading.
Okay, read it. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Read it.
Why are you here? Let's go.
What we go? We are here. I'm waiting for you. Read it. Here we go. The interpretation in front of you. Read it.
I'm waiting.
What it would mean? You're the one. I asked you. Do you know Arabic? You said yes. You said let us go. Here we go.
Course,
read it for me.
Of course.
Okay. Read it for me. Do you want to call a friend?
Al-Masih ibn Maryam.
You hold on. Why are you asking somebody else to read for you? Abdul, this is not even you. Potato, this is a recording. Potato, this is not you. Read for me. Don't play a sound. Don't play a recording. Read for me.
I'm recording you also, if you don't know.
No, read for me. Why you are playing for me a recording? I said to you, read.
Are you with me?
I am asking you, read. Why you are playing for me a recording?
I said you should read also. You didn't.
You said you know Arabic. You are a liar. I am getting you busted. Read for me what is in the screen.
Wait. I know you so much. This is how you argue. You look for a point and you stay there. Now, our argument now was not this.
Abdul, read the interpretation. I said to you, do you know Arabic? You came to know Arabic, and you said, let us go. It is you who will read for us. Admit that you are a liar. Admit you are a liar, and I will let it go. Admit that I was lying. I do not know Arabic. Say it.
Hello. What do you want to derive from this?
Say it.
What do you want to derive from this?
Well, I want you to read the interpretation.
Thank you. I said, take me to Quran. This is tafsir.
Shut up, you idiot. Is it a tafsir if you're a scholar? Aren't you the one who said to me, let us go? Do you see the cowards? Why you are calling me? If you are, you have to admit that you did lie, that you speak Arabic.
Hello?
Say in the front of everybody, I was lying. I do not know Arabic. Say it.
Don't tell me that.
I do not know Arabic. Please say it.
Should I tell you what do you know?
Then read it. I asked you, do you know Arabic? You said yes. I asked you, do you know Arabic? You said yes. I want you to read. Stop talking, wasting my time. Like you are like a pregnant woman in the delivery room. When we got you in the corner, you start screaming. Now I want you to please don't waste my time and your time. You claim that you speak Arabic. I am showing you Arabic in the screen. Read it for us.
Hello. This is what you gave me now. Hello? What you gave me just now, it is a tafsir. Do you agree with me?
I'm showing you tafsir. You're a scholar, don't you? I ask you which one you want.
I asked you which one you want. Take me to Arabic Quran. You gave me translation. I said, take me to Arabic Quran. You
don't get lost, donkey. Liar. I am here to spank you. I asked you, and you said you speak Arabic. When you read for me the Quran, by the way, they don't read Quran. They are not reading Arabic. They are liars. They have Quran written in their own language to resemble the sound of the Quran. They do not know Arabic. And now I show them the interpretation. They don't want to read it. And not only that. Let me show you the hypocrite, your prophet. It's your prophet, he swear and took an oath in the book of the Jews. How the Jews don't believe in Allah, you donkey. You are an insult to Islam. And you're a prophet, he took an oath. He swear by it. He told them, bring me the Torah. And they brought him the Torah. And then he said, read with me carefully. Muhammad, he said, bring the Torah. It was then brought. Then he would draw the cushion from beneath him. And he placed the Torah saying, I believe in thee and in him who revealed thee. This is the Torah was in the hand of the Jews in the time of Muhammad. Not the Torah which you Muslims claim. They might say, oh, he was believing in the Torah of Moses. So in order to avoid the contradiction where one verse in the Quran says the religion for Allah is only Islam, and the other verse says the Christians, even the Sabian worship stars. Sabian worship stars, they don't worship Allah. Unless your God Allah is a star, and he is. When your Quran says the Christians and the Jews and the Sabian, he brought three believe together, and he said all of them they will go to heaven. Now, do the Christians believe in Allah according to the Quran? Yes. According to me, we don't. Allah is a scumbag, is a lie. Do the Jews believe in Allah according to Quran? Yes. But the truth is, no, the Jews don't even know who's Allah. Sabian is the only one who believe in Allah, maybe, because Sabian are people who worship stars. And how in the world you put the Sabian between them? Is the Sabian from the people of the book? At this stage, Muhammad, he was trying to be a hypocrite to the Muslims. The liar, he said to us that the Jews and the Christians, their God is not Allah. But the verse after it says, I recall we took the covenant of the children of Israel to obey the Torah. This is what happened when you bring me a donkey to talk to me. Bring me an adult. They are a talking machine, but they say nothing but stupid words. Not only that, isn't it your God Allah who is the one who ordered the Jews to obey and respect Sabbath? And you are saying to me that Allah is not the God of the Jews according to Quran, you donkey? Isn't it him who made them pigs and monkeys because they broke the Sabbath, which is his Sabbath? You donkey? You today received a certification of a donkey from a Christian prince. And you know what? I think you are a better mule than Ustaz, the one who spoke to me before you. I want you to print today a certificate that you are a mule, Mr. Latif. You are not a donkey, you are higher. You are bigger. Do you speak Arabic? Yeah. So if I show you the tafsir, you read it? Yeah. Let us go. He thought I'm going to read for him, by the way. This is what he thought. He thought I will open that tafsir and I'll read for him and he will say blah 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 blah. It's going to go. He will make himself like look, he look Arabic. And look what he did. When I said to him, read Arabic, he played for me a recording. Did you notice? He played for me a recording for the verse in Arabic. To fool us that he is reading Arabic. This is how deceiving they are. I was listening, like, what happened to his voice? And what? Why he's reading this? I did not ask him to read that. You Nigerian Muslims are comedians. And you are wondering why Nigerians are leaving Islam? Your stupid ustaz, he said to me that Nasara are not the true Christians. Your stupid Quran says Nasara, they will go to heaven. Your stupid mule, you said to me, Nasara and the Jews, they don't worship Allah in the Quran. Your stupid Quran says that Allah, even the one who ordered them to obey the Sabbath, and he is the one who gave him the Torah. So if the Jews are not, they don't have God, his name is Allah, according to the Quran. So who is the one who gave the Torah? Who is the one who gave the Injil a donkey? They think if they scream loud, they can make themselves like look like they are smart. Look what your stupid Quran says. Who is the one who sent the Injil? Allah. He sent it to who? To Isa. So according to this book, the Quran saying that the God of the gospel of Isa is Allah. Yet your donkey, you say to me, Nasara, don't. According to the Quran. Remember, I was saying according to Quran, according to Quran. I wasn't saying according to me. I was asking him many times, according to the Quran, are you saying that the Jews and the Christians, their God is not Allah? He said, no, they are not. What a donkey. The same as the guy, his name Ustaz. What his name, the guy Ustaz? I forgot his name, man. I keep forgetting the name of this guy. I need to put his picture in the screen. Hold on. What his name? All my life I wanted to buy a tie, but I hate to wear a suit. What I can do, I mean, I don't fit there. But Ustaz, he's Ustaz, he wear a suit. What is the picture of Ustaz? Where is his name? Ustaz, huh? Yeah, right. Here we go. This is the Ustaz. This is their master, supposedly. This is the one who is teaching them. This guy, he said that the Nasara are not a true Christian according to Islam. But your God, he promised the Nasara to go to heaven, you donkey. This guy, he said that the word Nasara is coming from the Nazareth. And he is quoting for me from the Bible, which means he reject the Quran. He accept what is in the Bible. The word Nasara, according to the Quran, are the helpers of Jesus, you idiot. So this guy, when he said to us, this man, when he said that Nasara are not worshipping Allah according to the Quran, and Nasara are not different religion, sorry, they are different religion because they don't worship Allah supposedly, he just get himself busted. In the Quran it says, In chapter 3, verse number 52, he said, the Messiah, supposedly, Jesus, Isa in the Islam, who is the one who is going to follow me, is going to help me. And you will notice here that the Quran confirmed that the Nasara are even Muslims. The same verse. While the stupid donkey, Ustaz, he was debating me, saying the Nasara are not the true Christians. Don't post anything, even if it's Muhammad racist comment, don't post it in the text, otherwise people will think that you are saying that and then I have to ban you. Don't speak foolishness. Be careful. Don't quote what Muhammad said and make it look like you are the one saying it. Hello.
Hello, how are you, Christian Prince?
How are you, my friend?
Ah, great. Thank God for this more show for the Nigerian people, which I want you to do for more Africa. But I was just listening to the argument of your debate between the minister, the man from Nigeria, and what he's saying is that that Nasara are the real person that we Christian, even though we are not mentioned in the Bible. That is argument that the Nasara are not even Christian at all. That we Christian, we are not mentioned in the Quran at all. So we are pagan. So that's what his argument is about. That that the Nasara are mentioned in the Quran, but the Christian are not really mentioned. No.
He said they are not the true Christian. The second you say true Christian, it means the true ones who follow Jesus.
Yes, that's what he's saying.
But here the Quran saying clearly that this is what the Nasara are the helper of Jesus.
Yes.
The Quran confirmed that this guy is a donkey, because the Quran says that the word Nasara is the names of Jesus. He called them Ansari, which mean my helpers, who is going to support me, my supporters. So this is what Nasara according to the Quran. But according to that donkey, he is quoting from the Bible to prove a point that Nasara are those who they are, Nazareth. So he is contradicting the Quran and saying the Bible is right and the Quran is wrong.
So another thing is that I want you to do more of to enlighten more of African people, because we don't really know much about this. And I think if you please more show for this African, so for us to have the, because the main purpose of this is not to defend, because God, I believe we have to defend our religion, but at the end, I always say, if you defend what will not defend you, at the end you lose, because the main purpose is everyone to find out the truth where we are going, because this is about internal life.
We are not defending anything. We are just showing what it is. They are stupid people who have no idea, and they are liars, and they have no shame. They claim they speak Arabic, they don't know Arabic. They claim they have knowledge, they are donkeys. They say things even against their religion. They are cult, they are not even Muslims. Because any Muslim is a Muslim, he hears such a guy saying that the Nasara, according to the Quran, their God is not Allah, he will say right away, this guy is a false Muslim. So those idiots, they make themselves, they are people of knowledge, but they are donkeys. And this is what we are proving here. You know, I don't care really what people say, but this is what the Quran is teaching in front of us. And we can go and say search fatwa, or what the Quran actually, even the Fatiha saying that don't make us the same as the lost and the one is cursed. Who is the lost and who is the cursed? The Christian and the Jews. So according to Islam, the Nasara are the Christians, the Jews are the Jews, and the cursed one, Allah cursed them because they broke the Sabbath, and the Christians, they lost because simply they follow Jesus as God. You know,
as you always say, I think our heaven and their heaven is different. our heaven, and their heaven is different, because I think we should have not compared anything with them, because our heaven, which everyone is walking towards you, is different heaven. We are going to different heaven. And also, please, can you explain more about Surah chapter 5, because I mentioned it to him, Mr. Rooster. Surah chapter 5, verse 171.
Okay.
Surah chapter 5. No, Surah chapter 4 is 4. Chapter 4, verse 171.
Chapter 4?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, okay.
I think maybe you can explain better about that. Surah chapter 4, verse 171.
Yeah. Now, this guy is in the text, he is saying, I blocked him because simply you are a liar. You are lying to me. You are wasting my time. You say you speak Arabic. We show you the Arabic. You start playing for me a recording. And I don't want to waste my time. Everybody is laughing at you. Shame on you. Shame on you to claim that you know Arabic and you speak Arabic and you read Arabic when the fact you don't even know two letters in Arabic. Why I want to waste my time with somebody making me shout and scream, and he don't want even to prove what he just said. Now I challenge you to make a video and to say to the Muslims that according to Quran, Nasara are not worshiping Allah, and you will see how many Muslims will throw their shoes at you. You donkey. Anything else, my friend?
Yeah, thank you very much. Please allow him to talk so we can save more people, because I know he's not only one listening to it. If a guy want to be truthful, let it be truthful. And because you are helping others that are listening to it, I believe that, because when you do your video, not only, even though if the Muslim don't call, the word of
hold
God.
Hold on. I got a Muslim. Sorry, I have to hang up on you. Hey, Kareem, how are you? Hey, Moroccan guy, how are you? Hello. I will make this guy get you busted, Abdul, the Nigerian boy. He's a Moroccan. How are you, Moroccan guy?
Fine, my friend. I'm
fine. Your voice is cutting. Please go close the apps if there's many.
Okay.
Let me ask you, Kareem or Muhammad, whatever your name. According to the Quran. Was the Nasara their God is Allah? Yes or not?
Repeat the question.
According to the Quran, the Nasara, yes. which the Quran mentioned their name, do they believe in Allah according to the Quran? Yes or no?
Some of them not.
Who are the some who don't believe in Allah? Can you show me one verse? Don't it says that some of the Nasara don't believe in Allah?
It is the verse where Allah says, only the Nasara who believe in Allah will give their rewards
show me where it says some of the Nasara don't believe in Allah. I want to see the verse.
Which verse?
You just said that some of the Nasara don't believe in Allah. Some, right? You said some. Okay, where is the verse says some of the Nasara don't believe in Allah?
This is understanding from the verse that I quote you.
Which
because
one?
Because Allah said.
Which one?
The verse where I don't remember the.
Didn't even know the Quran. Christian Prince had to remind them. The Ladina Hadu, correct? The Nasara and those who they are the Jews. Okay. So where it says some of them there?
Show me the verse.
You see, but they keep saying to me, show me. You know the verse. You know you speak Arabic. Where it says the word some there? Where it says some of them? Can you show me?
Can you read the verse?
It's in the front of you.
Wait, because the connection, I don't
see. Okay, I'll read for you then. Here we go. I'll read for you. As long as you cannot see it, it's taking time. In الذين آمنوا والذين هادوا والنصارى والصابئين ومن آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وعمل صالحا فلهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Now, where is the word some?
You see, when Allah says, men, it's some, men, Who either believe?
He's adding wa. Do you know what wa? Do you know what wa mean? What wa mean? What wa mean? What wa mean? Okay, what wa mean? Okay, what wa mean? Okay, let me ask you. Okay, hold on. Let me show you the stupidity of the Muslims. So when the Quran says, hold on, when the what condition? What condition? The condition is if you are a Jew, if you are a Nasara, if you are a Sabian, and if you believe in Allah, if you believe in the last day, you are going to go to heaven. Correct?
You must believe in Allah.
All right, okay, but according to the Quran, all the Quran says, even the Nasara who will go to hell, they believe in Allah, they are mushrikeen.
But not in Allah. That's
do you know what mushrikeen mean? No, they believe in Allah. Believe in Allah. Show me one verse says that the Christians, the Nasara here, and the Jews don't believe in Allah. Show me. What's wrong with those donkeys? Abdul, listen. Isn't it the Quran says that those who believe that Allah, they worship beside Allah, the Messiah, they are kuffar?
Yes.
Okay, that's mean they believe Allah and the Messiah.
So what
do you mean, so what? You were saying to me that this is some. With the question was, do the Christians, according to the Quran, the Nasara, do they believe in Allah? Yes or no? So the Quran confirmed that no. All the Nasara and all the Jews, they believe in Allah, but they worship beside Allah someone else, correct?
This is why they will not go to heaven.
Abdul, this is another question. The Quran teach, focus with me. Moroccan people, stop taking hashish. Listen, Abdul, does the Quran says that Uzair is the son of Allah and the Christian, they say the Messiah is the son of Allah, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, that's mean they believe in Allah too.
You will go to heaven.
You're stupid. What's wrong with you?
You will go to heaven.
This is not the question. This is not the question, you donkey. This is not the question. The question is, your brother before you, he was saying, and I ask you the same question, do the Nasara, according to the Quran, believe in Allah or not? You answer me saying some.
They believe in Allah, but also with a son of God.
That's it. That's what I was saying. So they believe in Allah. Just go, man.
So what?
Just shut up. So what? This is the whole point. You're a stupid donkey before you, and you, we asked you, do the Nasara and the Jews believe in Allah? I did not ask you if they believe in Allah alone. I said, do they believe in Allah? You said no. Some. The other donkey says all of them don't believe in Allah. How they believe he is the son of Allah, you idiot. But you don't believe in Allah. How the Jews believe that Uzair is son of Allah, and the Christian believe that Isa is the son of Allah, but yet they don't believe in Allah. I mean, who is the donkey here? My printer is out of a certification. I cannot give more certification to Muslims. We need more ink. Okay, Muhammad, I want to give you an opportunity to make us Muslim. Give me something good about your prophet or about the Quran to make us believe that this is a book of God.
Let me refute that your points, your last point.
Refute? You agreed with me. You agreed that the Jews and the Christian, according to the Quran, they believe in Allah. Yes or no?
Let me respond.
Yes or no? You agreed.
It is not just yes or no. Let me explain it more.
I am not asking you if they believe in Allah alone or not. I am saying to you, Abdul, focus, stop hashish. According to the Quran, is the God of according to the Quran, is the God of the Jews and the Christians is Allah? Is he considered as God for them? Yes or no?
If you believe that Allah has a son, then you don't believe in Allah, because Allah tells you that he
this is not a question, you donkey. This is not, you see why I call you donkeys, Muslims? I am not asking you if they believe someone beside now. I'm asking you, is they have a God? His name is Allah. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, so shut up. So what are you trying? You want to refute me? And that's why I'm quoting for you. You Muslims are stupid when you don't listen. We are debating about what? Your Muslim friends, they are saying from Nigeria. Shut up.
I don't listen to them.
The Muslims, I don't care if you listen or not. Why you call me before you listen? Listen first before you call. Listen, this is not my fault. So I ask you, do the Christians believe in God? His name is Allah. You said to me, some. That's stupid of you to say. No, there's no some. The Quran confirmed that all the Nasara believe in God, his name is Allah. The only difference is that they believe that Allah, and they believe in the Son of Allah. The same as the Jews, they believe in Allah and the Son of Allah, correct?
If you go to Jerusalem, you will see that it's a part of, it's not all Christians.
Doesn't matter. This is not the question. Don't be an idiot.
This is my point.
Don't be an idiot. This is not the question. The question is, according to the Quran, do all the Nasara believe in a God, his name is Allah? Yes or no?
Yes, but what is the
shut up then? Don't call me again, man. I mean, those people are really, really making me sick. Don't call me ever again. I mean, how many times I need to repeat? I lost my voice. Liars. And by the way, let me get into the good news. We don't believe in anything have to do with Allah. Your God Allah is nothing but an idol. And we are not Nasara. And let me tell you another news. Your prophet is a big fat liar. There's not a single Jew believing a guy. His name is Uzair. He is a son of Allah. And I challenge you to find me a verse from the Old Testament saying that there is a guy, his name is Uzair, he is a son of Allah. Your God is nothing but a scam. His name is Muhammad. Where are the Jews who believe in the son of Allah? His name is Uzair. Can you show me? Somebody is saying to me, don't use donkey, use jackass. No, I like donkey. Don't like it, it's up to you. I have a copyright over it. You see the madness of this? But anyway, you know, all of this garbage, I mean, who cares? But the whole Quran is stupid. They claim that they knew, and each time they try to talk, they get themselves busted. And not only that, in this verse it says that the Christian believe that Christ is Son of Allah. In different verse it says that they believe that Christ is Allah. Who is the stupid here? Which one of them is correct? Well, there's a difference. If you say that the Messiah is the Son of Allah, that means there's no Trinity. Because that's it, Allah Himself is the Messiah. So one verse saying that those who say the Messiah is Allah, they are kuffar, and one verse saying that the Christian believe that the Messiah is the Son of Allah. Which one is accurate? Christians believe that we have a person, His name is Jesus, the Messiah. We have the Holy Spirit is a person, as a Holy Spirit. We have the Father is a person. So either you are confused about the Trinity as a Muhammad, and you do not know what the Trinity is about. So sometimes you say the Christian, they believe that the Christ himself is the same person as Allah, or same person as God, which is the Father. And this is not what we believe. One God, but the Messiah is a person. He is the Word of God. This is what the Bible says. In the beginning it was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word is the God. When you speak about the Messiah, you speak about the person who is a man now, and you call him Isa. And Isa is a person. According to the Quran, the Christian believe that he is Allah. According to different verse, he is son of Allah. In the top of that, other verse says that the Trinity is Mary, and is Isa, and is Allah. Let us see, we have some Abdul trying to call. Look like your internet is horrible, my friend. What I can do for you? Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
My name is Olaitan from Nigeria.
You're welcome, my friend. How I can help you?
I want to contribute to your program. I've been following you for some while, and my question will be based on the Bible itself, because I'm very, very, very interested in the Bible, and I would like to discuss with you and to give me the answer to my question with the reference from the Bible.
Are you a Muslim?
Yeah, I'm a Muslim.
Okay, which Bible you want to read from? The Bible of the Christians or the Bible of Allah?
What do you have? Which of the Bible do you have with you there?
I'm asking you, which Bible you have?
I have King James. Okay, Revised Standard.
Why you don't ask me from the Bible of Allah?
You said?
Why you don't ask me the question from the Bible of Allah?
I don't know. Maybe I don't have any Bible. The Bible that I know that is existing is the Bible that I just mentioned to you now.
I know, but according to the Quran, it is Allah who sent the Injil, correct?
I don't want to debate on the Quran.
I'm not debating about the Quran. I'm debating about the
Bible. It is the question. It is a question I'm talking about. I'm not here to debate now.
I'm not debating you. I'm asking you.
Okay, let me ask my question.
You said to me you have a question about the Bible, correct?
Let me throw my question first. So give me an answer from the Bible.
Because I want to understand which book you are going to read for me from. Why you don't want to read for me from the book of Allah, which is the Injil?
Now, okay, let us do it in this way. Before me here presently, I have Revised Standard Bible, I have Good News Bible, I have New International Version of the Bible.
Is that the book of Allah?
Wait, let me learn. Which of these Bibles is original?
None of them is original. None.
But why are you claiming to be right?
Let me ask you the same question. Which one of the Quran, of the following Quran, is original? Yusuf Ali Listen. Or Bektal. Hold on. Let me show you. Let me show you how naive you are, my friend. Those what you have is a translation. You asked me a question. Let me answer you.
You cannot ask me any question because I'm not.
You asked me a question. Let me answer you. Can I answer you, please? Can I answer you?
I need your answer from the Bible.
Let me speak, man. What's wrong with those Let me answer you. You idiot. We have the Hebrew original. We have the Aramaic original. We have the Greek original. I am asking you now the same question. Where the Quran, the original?
What I'm saying, I'm not talking about Quran. I don't want to.
I am not talking about Quran too. You are the one who's asking about original. I'm asking you. We have the original. We have the Aramaic.
Abdul,
don't be a donkey. Don't be a donkey. Stop it. Stop it. You don't have Quran. You don't have a Quran. Hold on. You don't have a Quran. I challenge you to show me the Quran. Where is the Quran?
I'm telling you that you are a Christian, right?
Where is the Quran? I have the original Bible. I have the Aramaic. I have the Hebrew. I have the Greek. This is the original. Where is your Quran? The Quran in front of me, according to the Muslim, is the Quran of Uthman. Is the Quran of Uthman? Is that correct?
I'm asking you a question from your book. I'm not talking about Quran here.
There's nothing called my book, you idiot. This is the book of Allah according to the Quran. So why you don't give me a question from the book of Allah, which is the Bible? I want you to show me the Bible. Are you saying to us that your God Allah is a stupid God? He could not keep his book.
You understand Quran?
I understand your Quran. I understand what it's saying. It's in front of us. It says that Allah is the one who sent the Injil. Did your God Allah send? He sent the Injil. Yes or no?
Do you understand Quran?
Yes, sure. Do you? Yes, do you?
Okay, you do. If you understand the Quran, am I myself that I'm talking to you now, I'm not here to debate or to ask any question concerning the Quran. Just leave me and leave the Quran.
No problem. I'm not debating about the Quran now. I'm asking you. You want to debate me about... hold on. You want to talk about the Bible, right? I answered you. I said to you, we have many translation, the same as you have many translation to the Quran. Now, the same question you asked me, I have the right to ask you. Where is the real Quran?
You are not in any position to ask me any question.
Why not? No, I am here. I have the position. I am the one who have a position. The same the question you asked me, I answered you. We have the Bible in Aramaic, we have the Bible in Hebrew, we have the Bible in Greek, and this is the original. Now, where we can find the original
English
Quran?
Translation. Where? From the English translation.
No, those are translations because you are a donkey. You do not know the language. This is the whole point. So, this is not... Abdul, do you know the Quran?
Okay.
Do you read the Quran in your language or in English? Do you read the Quran? Do you read the Quran in the Arabic language? Yes or no?
From you, and you are telling the person a donkey. Is this Christianity you are propagating? You are preaching?
Yes, because the Quran, you're a prophet, he called you donkey. Yes, your prophet, he called you a donkey. Yes, yes. Let me show you. Hold on, let me show you. Here we go. Are you saying your prophet is a bad man? Your prophet, he called you a donkey. Read it. Hold on. Shut up. Did your prophet say you are a donkey? Yes or no? Did your prophet say you are a donkey or not?
I can join you in your arrogance, and
it's your prophet. He said you are a donkey. Read it. Muhammad, he said, does any one of you who raise his head before the Imam not fear that Allah may turn his head into a head of a donkey? And actually, Muhammad is right. Because you are asking me if the translation of the Bible is the original, and you should know that this is a translation, you donkey. Doesn't say there, this is translation. When you say to me, I have the book, it's called etc., the book, etc., this is a translation, you idiot. I mean, how silly are you? And this is the question you brought to me? So you squeeze your ass for an hour to call me to say to me, I have King James version, I have English translation version, I have Aramaic translation version, I have this is a translation, you donkey. The same as you have Ahmed Ali and Musa Ali and Musa Yusuf. So did I answer you, my friend? Did you hear my answer? Did you hear my answer? Mute YouTube.
Look at you. Look at you. I'm asking you a question and you are abusing me. You don't even know who is talking to you.
I answered you. You are not the one that's answering. I answered you. I said to you, shut up. You see, this way. Listen. If we keep talking at the same time, if we give no chance to talk, there's no need to talk. Are you going to give me a chance to talk?
If this is the Christianity you are inviting.
Yes, this is a Christianity. In here we spank people. This is Christianity. This is what Jesus did. Jesus, he called people like you the son of vipers, liars. You follow your father, the devil. This is what Jesus said. You want to show you the verses? Now I'm asking you. You are a Muslim who says to us that you have God who prevents. Shut up, you idiot. You will not let me talk, you donkey. What kind of conversation this conversation is? I want you to record my voice, and by the way, you do not need to record. You can take the video from here, and I challenge the Muslim to post my video in their pages. It's a challenge. Why you keep calling me? You will not let me talk. You will let me talk.
Can I imagine?
You will let me talk.
I'm asking you a question, and you are abusing me. If this is the question,
Hold on. Are you going to let me talk or not?
Because someone is asking you questions.
Are you going to let me talk or not?
People asking you because you are abusing them, insulting them, insulting their God. Is this what you are taught?
Yes, this is what I taught. Yes, this is what I taught. Yes, yes, yes. Because your God, you donkey, don't call me again. Don't talk about insult, you filthy coward. Your God, he called us kuffar. Your God called us pigs. Your God called us monkeys. Your God called us najis. Your God called us worst of the creatures. And then you are talking to me that you are a person who have a good manner. I did not call you a kafir. I did not call you a pig. I did not call you a monkey. I did not call you worst of creatures. I call you donkey. And as you see, your prophet himself, he is saying, he is warning you, if you raise your head before a Christian prince, Allah will make your head the head of a donkey. You scream too much to avoid the topic. You ask me, which book of those books are the true Bible? I answered you, you are a fool. Those are translations. None of them is the true Bible. For this is a translation. This is a translation, not the manuscript. The same as Yusuf Ali is a translation. The same as Bictal is a translation. You are a certified donkey, not only a donkey. Same time, if we ask the Muslims, the Quran we have in front of us, this is the Quran of who? They say this is the Quran according to Uthman. But guess what? Even the book of Uthman, they don't have it. Not a single Muslim have the book of Uthman. Let me show you something. I will show you what is written in the Quran. That this book is according to. Nothing but according to. But nobody have the book of Uthman. Not a single Muslim have it. They have recitation of a guy, his name is Hafs, which a guy, he came 200 years after Muhammad. And by the way, even the book of Hafs is not exist. This is according to the recitation of Hafs. But let me show you what is written in the Quran. I'm looking for the page in Arabic so we can read together and everybody will laugh. Here we go. Read and love with me. Riwayatu hadha al-mushaf wa mustalahatu rasmihi wa dhabtihi according كتب هذا المصحف الكريم وضبط على ما يوافق رواية حفص. رواية حفص. The tale of حفص. The tale of who? حفص. Who is حفص? حفص, according to Muslims, and all Muslims agree, accused to be a fraud, a liar, a scammer, and a thief. Not only that, according to حفص, ابن سليمان ابن المغيرة الأسدي الكوفي لقراءة عاصف, according to the reading of عاصم. Who is عاصم? The same scumbag. عاصم is the stepfather of حفص. عاصم was accused to be a fraud, a thief, and not only that, both of them, حفص and عاصم, their hadith is rejected because they are certified liars. What is the Quran? And then they continue saying, according to Abi Abdurrahman Abdullah al-Asadi al-Kufi, Suleiman al-Mughira Asad al-Kufi, according to Asim ibn Abi Nujud al-Kufi, according to Abi Abdullah Abdurrahman ibn Habib al-Sulma, according to Uthman, according to Ali, according to Zayd ibn Thabit, according to the Prophet. According to, but we don't have zero of those books. Not even one. And the disaster is not only here. The disaster is that the Quran says that Allah forbid the Muslims from collecting the Quran. Do you know that? The Quran forbid any Muslim from collecting anything. It's called Quran. If we go in the Quran, we will find the following. Read and love. Inna alayna jam'uhu wa qur'anuhu. Allah, he said, it is on us to collect the Quran. Chapter 75, verse number 17. It is not on Uthman. It is not the duty of the Muslims. Allah forbid the Muslims from collecting the Quran. Allah, he promised the Muslims that he is the one who will collect it. And you see here between two brackets, they say in your heart, it doesn't say that. Because the Muslims, they try to explain how Allah will collect the Quran. He never did. So they have to add between two brackets. In Arabic, it says nothing about that. Inna alayna jam'uhu wa qur'anahu. Same time, the Muslims, they say and they claim that the Quran is collected in the heart of the believers. Muhammad himself, he forgot Quran. And I can show you tons of examples how Muhammad forget the Quran. Let's see if we can find. All right, let's see. Muhammad, he forgot the Quran. By the way, not only I will show you the hadith, I will show you the Quran confirm that even Muhammad and the Muslims, they forget the Quran. Let me get you the reference. I'm trying just to find it for you in English, so they will not say we are making things up. Here we go. A Muslim, he remind him of verses on Quran and chapters he forgot. This is the Prophet of Islam himself, forgetting the Quran. But guess what? This is Sahih Hadith. What does that mean? That means Muhammad is a scam. Why? Because there's a verse in the Quran, it says, سَنُقْرُؤُكَ فَلَا تَنْسَى. We are going to give you Quran, and you will never forget. Chapter 87, verse number 6. Do you see it, guys? Muhammad, he claimed that his God promised him that he will give him Quran, and he will never forgive the Quran. My friend Asani, yeah, we make money here. I am like your prophet who said, if you want to see the prophet in the private, you have to pay him money. Did you pay me to call me? You see how low they are? You talk about money, all your religion is about money. Even your God, Allah, he beg for money. And he says, if you pay him money, he forgive your sin. I forgive sin for nobody. And did you pay me to speak to me, Latif? How Latif you are. Let us see what Muhammad, he said. As long as you are talking about money and expose the scam of your prophet. Chapter 9, verse number 103. It says, of their goods take alms, so thou mightst purify and sanctify them and pray in their behalf. Are you talking about money? If you pay your prophet, he will pray in your behalf. God prophet, if I pay him, he will pray in my behalf and he will sanctify me. Isn't it obvious that this is a scam? What do you say? No, I will give you a chance to call me if you are willing to talk about money. Is that correct, guys? I will give you a chance. First of all, you have to promise me two things. We don't talk in the same time. If I talk, you stop talking, and I will give you time to talk. All right? And that will be fair. Is that fair, guys? And I want you, I will go back to zero. I will put the reference for in front of us in Arabic, and I want you to read for us in Arabic. We will start from there. Do you agree? Are you brave enough to say I agree? Say yes, and I will unblock you. Say yes. Say yes. I'm waiting for you. Say yes, be a man. Hello? No, no, there's no unjust block me. I want you to promise me that you will read for me what you asked me to show you, and you promise me that we will not talk in the same time over each other. I will give you time to talk. I promise in front of everybody. I will give you 2 minutes to talk. 1 minute for me. Do you accept? Do you accept? You don't talk over me, I don't talk over you. No, don't tell me I promise. Don't tell me I promise. Don't tell me, just pick up. What was your name? Let me search for your name. Okay, he said okay, guys. So he promised. Call me, go ahead. Call me. Can you start reading for us? The Arabic, you claim that you know Arabic. All right, we hear you. I'm going to give you 2 minutes and I will not talk during those 2 minutes. Do you hear me?
Hello, hello. Let me just okay. Let me tell something.
Do you hear
something
me? Do you hear
system.
Me?
The system I'm using to watch, the system I'm using to watch is off. I'm using my phone to charge.
No problem.
Hello?
No problem.
I cannot see anymore. I cannot see. Let's just talk. I have proofs.
No problem. I can give you the link. No. Hold on. I can give you the link to your text, to your Skype, and you can open it there. There's no problem. Let me give you the link.
I have just one. I have just a phone. My system is off.
Doesn't matter. You can open. No, you can open the link there, and you can read from there. Do you want to send you a snapshot?
From my phone? This same phone?
I can send you to your phone, yes, a snapshot in the Skype. Aren't you in Skype? We're talking Skype.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
Let me send you a snapshot, and you read for me from the snapshot. All right. Okay. Here we go. This is the snapshot. Open it and read it.
Waiting. I've not seen it.
It's there.
I'll see it. I'm still here. I've not seen anything.
A friend, I send it to you. It is in your Skype. Stop playing games.
I'm not playing. I'm serious. God made me. I've not seen it.
You were in YouTube a second ago, and you were texting, and YouTube is running. Now you cannot see it.
Listen, I can't watch you again. I'm using the same phone. Okay. I'm using the same phone.
No problem. Let us do this. I will give you a chance. I will hang up on you. You take a snapshot yourself from YouTube, and you call me back.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. It's in the front of you. I send you the snapshot. You can't say I did not send it to you. As you see. Waiting for you. Let us see for how long he will keep his promise not to shout and speak over me. Go ahead.
Please, I want you to teach me something. I can view it now. But when I view, when I'm calling now, I can't view anymore. Teach me that. I can't view.
How you were able before to read the verses I was showing you in the Quran before?
Yeah, that's what I told you now. That's what I told you. I'm using a system.
No, my friend, I was showing you the verses. You were saying to me, show me, and I showed you, and you were reading for me. Now suddenly you cannot see.
Yes, I can't lie. Me, I am a good Muslim. I don't lie. I'm using a Lenovo system to read.
Okay.
Now the Lenovo battery is
gone. I gave you a link. Did you open the link?
Yeah, this is now when I caught now. I saw it on my Snapchat. I can view. Now that I'm calling now, I can't view anymore. That's what I'm saying. If I can do it, just tell me. Let me do it.
Isn't it YouTube open for you? Just hide the Skype and you look on YouTube, you will see it. How you were looking before? Okay. How you were seeing the sky? The verses I was showing you before.
Yeah, I'm watching you at the same time. I'm using my phone to call. I'm using the phone to call.
I know you were using your phone when you called me before too, and you were showing the verses and you were reading for me the verses. And you are the one who said to me, "Show me in Arabic." Remember, I show it to you in English. Yes. And then you said to me, "Show me in Arabic." and then you were able to read it. So now how come you cannot see it?
Do you understand?
My friend, you are a liar. You do not know Arabic. Just say I do not know Arabic. Just say I do not know Arabic. Say it.
Hello. I don't want to argue.
Do you know Arabic or not? Be honest. Do you know Arabic or not?
I know Arabic. Okay. I go to Arabic school. All right,
no problem. I want you to open At-Tabari, Tafsir At-Tabari, to the verse we are talking about.
Okay. At-Tabari.
And read it for us. Here we go.
Hello. Why are you like this? I told you something.
Just get lost. Suddenly he cannot see it now. Go guys and watch the video. I was showing him in the screen. I was highlighting in the screen. He asked me to switch from English to Arabic. He can see it perfectly, and now he cannot see it. The whole idea is he will make me just give up and say, okay, forget about it. Taqiyya. How you were saying to me before, move it here. Okay, show me the Arabic. Okay, show me the English. Oh, here we go. It's in the front of you. It says in English, and you start reading for me. Suddenly, now you cannot read it. Not only that, I showed him the same page. He asked a guy to come and read. I heard his voice. And then he started playing a recording for us. He was showing the guy. We heard him. Hypocrite liars. I have no need of you, my friend, no more. You are like a shoe which have many holes. I'm not going to get my socks wet. Sorry. You Muslim, you want to debate Christian friends? Are you kidding me? Stupid. You see, not only you are following the false God, which is teaching you to lie, you are even his followers are not even smart, which additional proof that your God is a fake God. Can't your God now give you extra intelligence so you can even lie better? Christianity is an insult. Absolutely. Christianity is an insult to donkeys. A person who believe that he wanna go to heaven and his penis will be endless. For you, this is a true God. Huh? A God who promised you that in the heaven you will have women, you will see the marrow of their bones because he's racist. A God who promised you that in the heaven of Allah, all the believers will be white. For he's a racist. Have you ever heard of a racist, filthy God like this? According to Islam, nobody will enter heaven unless they are white. It's a must. Everybody, Allah will make him either white or black. And this is now the heaven, and this is the God. My God, he will not change your color to go to heaven. My God, he loves you if you are a black or Asian, or doesn't matter if you are white. Your God accept no black. Not only that, your God taught the Muslims to kill animals just because they are black. Any animal which is a pure black, he must be killed according to the racist Muhammad, the prophet of Allah. How you can follow such a filthy man? You're a prophet. He said that the black people are raising head. How you can accept somebody to call you such a name? Not only that, by the way, do you know that the most person Allah he hate is a black man? Do you believe it? No problem, my friend. Thank you for donation. Too bad. I am not Muhammad to promise you heaven if you donate to me. If you donate to Muhammad, he will forgive your sin. What a scam. You pay him you pay him money, all your sin is gone. Chapter 64, verse number 17. If you donate to Christian Prince, my friend, I cannot forgive your sin. Sorry. So look at this, look at this madness. Those poor Nigerian who they are African, they are following a guy who hate black people. How dare you? He even want to kill animals because he believe that animals who they are black must be killed. Why? Because they are shaitan. Shaitan. I ask the messenger of Allah about all black dog, and he said it is the devil. Is it sahih? Yes, it is sahih. Not only that, who is the most person Allah he hate? He is a black. Read with me and see this filthy cult. I seek refuge on him from the evil and the black. In the translation, they don't show it. Where is the black? Oh, here they are. The word is a serpent. Serpent? Hmm. That's a nice one. What else? Let us show you a different one. And this is sahih. The most hateful among the creation of Allah is the one black man among them. And here they put the word Khawarij. By the way, it's not there. This is a fabrication, it's not in the hadith. But doesn't matter. Why is black? Why the most hateful person for Allah is a black person? What about saying he is a kafir, he is bad, he is... Why you are saying he is a black? Am I making things up? This is Sahih Muslim, and this is Sahih. Do you see it? This is not Muhammad. The one who's talking is Muhammad, you idiot. What not Muhammad? The one who's talking is Muhammad. And not only that. If you go to chapter 27, verse number 82, and you know what? Let us see the interpretation so the Muslim, they will not say I'm making things up. You know them. I mean, you know them. You are a liar. We go to Ibn Kathir. Chapter 27, verse number 82. Bingo. The God of Islam, he will send in the judgment day a beast. And this beast will come from the ground, and he will have the staff of Moses and the stick of Solomon. And he will strike the nose of the disbeliever with the staff, and he will make him black. Read carefully with me. After describing the funny beast, they says, it will bring out with it staff of Moses and the ring of Suleiman. There will be no believer left without it making a white spot on his face, which will spread until all his face shining white as a result. And there will be no disbeliever left without making a black spot on his face, which will spread until all his face is black as a result. Am I lying? Am I lying, Muslims? This is the book of Ibn Kathir, and this is your translation, and this is your website. This is the God you follow? What a filthy God. By the way, not only Allah will make you black and white, Allah will put a flag in your anus. I'm so happy for you, Mr. Latif, that you will have a flag in your anus. Finally, you became an ambassador. I hope it's not going to hurt. I know all your life you wish to be an ambassador for Allah. Finally, you got a flag in your anus. Have you ever heard of a silly, stupid God like this? Flag in the anus? Do we have any Abdul? Buttocks. How you pronounce buttocks? Somebody teach me English, please, because I'm illiterate like the Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him. Buttocks. Show respect, please. Buttocks. It's not in his anus. It's his buttocks. Correction. I mean, what kind of a stupid religion this religion is? This is God? Buttocks mean bomb? Masha Allah, you have knowledge, my friend. May Allah bless you with your knowledge and your knowing a lot about buttocks. Do we have any Muslim here who would like to say something? So as you see, they are silly. They have nothing to say. They shout, they scream in order to stop you from talking, but they have nothing really to say. And look at this crazy, stupid religion. Who in the world, and how, especially if you are a black person, how in the world you accept such a cult? Shame on you. They keep saying to us, Bilal, the poor guy was begging for freedom. And yet Muhammad don't want to free him. And then he went to Abu Bakr. He says, if you bought me for yourself, please free me for your, keep me for yourself. If you bought me for the sake of Allah, free me for the sake of Allah. How this is can be a prophet of God? The black bird is a devil. The black snake is a devil. The black cat is the devil. Anything is a pure black is a devil. Not only that, Muhammad, he confirmed. But Allah created the black people for hell. You believe it? Narrated Abu Durada. Abu Durata. Allah Messenger, peace be upon him, said. Who is the one who's talking? Allah Messenger, peace be upon him. I feel like crying from the racism. Allah Messenger said, Allah created Adam when he created him, and he struck him, struck his right shoulder. And there emitted from it white of spring. From where? From his right shoulder. Science. As if they were white ants. And then he struck his left shoulder, and there emitted from it black offspring, as if they were charcoal. And then he said, to those who have been emitted from the right shoulder for paradise, and I don't mind. And he said, those who had been emitted from the left shoulder, which means the black, they are for hell, and I don't mind. What a filthy God. Christians, do Jesus teach us that the black people will go to hell? Do Jesus teach us that Asian people will go to hell? Do Jesus teach us that only white people, they are going to go to heaven? That is absolutely not the teaching of Jesus. Jesus, he said to them, go and teach the whole world. For God, he loved the world. He sent his only begotten son. He loved the whole world, not the black, not the white, not the Hindus, not, doesn't matter who you are. He loved the whole world. This is your God, my friend. This is your God. And as you see, everything we show it even with reference from your Islamic schools. This is not my words. This is not my text. This is not my website. This is your Muslim library. When I say I speak Arabic, I mean it. Muslims, they say they speak Arabic, they lie. Muslims, they claim they know Islam, they lie. They don't even know what Muhammad mean, what Allah mean, what Isa mean, what Israel mean, what Ibrahim mean, what Jibreel mean, what Mikael mean. I mean, they know nothing. Yet they want to teach you about God. What a scam. How dare you to be a black person and you follow such a racist, disgusting man. His name is Muhammad. My Lord. Very stupid and foolish. Guys, Asani, he agree that his prophet is very foolish and stupid. And I agree with you. Look what Muhammad, he said about how foolish he is. Not only he is racist. Just to show you that Muhammad is, as you said, Asani, he is certified foolish. Look at this. You're a prophet, he claimed, that if your wife have orgasm first, the baby will look like her and will be a female. And if you have orgasm first, your baby will be a male. Now, according to what I know, neither Muhammad or his wives ever have orgasm, and I can show it to you. But I don't know the case about you. Muhammad is said, Sahih Hadith. Sahih. Is that Sahih? Sahih Hadith. Oh, this is weak. This is weak. Don't say that. The prophet did not say that. This is stupid. There's no way the prophet will say such a thing. This is weak. Sahih. 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 Oh, hold on. The Muslims, they don't like it this way. I have to say it with echo. Brothers and sisters, this is Sahih, 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 Sahih. It's confirmed to be Sahih, Sahih, authentic. Scientific. And I know exactly what happened in the bedroom of my father and my mother. Obviously, man, what happened here? Hold on. The Muslim did describe how Muhammad looked like and how his father looked like and how his mother looked like, but he don't look like any of them. Oh boy. Let it go. Who is a Muslim when I believe that this guy is a prophet of God? Any Muslim? You know, the funny they say to me, a Christian prince is the dump here. I'm not the one who's saying that. Guys, who is the dump here? I am the one who says whoever comes first, the baby will resemble the parents. And you are calling me dumb? You idiot? Everybody is laughing at your prophet. Just get lost, kid. Coward, liar, potato. Let the man of the house call me. Let your mom call me. And the funny they say is that what the Christianity taught you to say donkey. His God, he called us pigs, monkeys, najis, which means filthy, dirty, the worst of the creatures. Kuffar, I mean a list of names. Not only that, the Muslim, they curse us 5 times a day. By the way, it's proven by science. If we call Zakir Naik, he will say the following. Let us call him. Tereden, tereden. Tereden, tereden. Zakir Naik can never answer the phone unless it rings 3 times because he's like the prophet. He is consistent with the Trinity. Tereden, tereden. Hello, brother Zakir Naik, we have a question for you. I told you 1,000 times, don't call me. Don't call me. Brother, we have a question. It's very serious. And you are a doctor, so we have no choice. Not like others who they are not educated. You are a doctor. I agree with you. I'm a doctor. And there is nobody like me. And I affect thee, and I know it. What is the question? The hadith says that the messenger of Allah said, the man water is thick and white, and the woman water is thin and yellow. And which one of them comes first, the child will resemble the parent. Explain to us. As you know, I'm a doctor, and I graduated from Bangladesh. And you know that the grading in the Bangladesh is a very high degree. And I speak Arabic, and I speak English better than you. Zakir Naik, you speak Arabic? Take the Arabic off. I speak English better than you. Forget about Arabic. Ah, okay. When the Prophet, he said that whoever come first, it means whoever come first at home, not about orgasm. What? An example. Me and my wife, we are working together. If she arrive home first, the baby will resemble her. If I arrive first, the baby will resemble her. What are you talking about? This is about orgasm. Don't lie. It said whoever come first. Whoever come first. But there is talking about the water of the man is white and thick. So he's talking about orgasm. Let me explain to you. We add Muslim before we arrive home. We put white water in front of us. Before you go home, you put white water and it is thick. Yes. What is that water? It's a sperm. It's what? Sperm. So you put water, which is a sperm, before you enter the house. Where the sperm is coming from? I can't tell you. Because this is something have to do with ritual. This is a ritual? Absolutely. And it says there that the women, she have water which is white and yellow. What is that? Actually, this is about my wife. She always piss around. She do what? She piss around. She piss around? Absolutely. Dr. Zakir Naik, I am really astonished with your interpretation. I never heard this before. Absolutely, because simply I told you, I am graduated from the highest degree in Bangladesh. And even Imran Khan, the Prime Minister of Pakistan, he always asked me to fix his teeth. Fix his what? His teeth. I thought you are not a dentist. It doesn't matter in Islam. All of it is the same. Okay, Dr. Zakir Naik, I'm really happy to hear your interpretation. Thank you very much. Before you go, if you call me one more time, I will report you for sexual harassment. But why you are saying sexual harassment? Because all what you talk to me about sex. You're trying to make me horny. Okay, you get a point here. All right, take care. I'm not sure how many of you are convinced that the prophet is a prophet yet, but if you are not convinced, you better consider. How in the world do you Muslims believe in such a garbage, man? I mean, what's wrong with you? What do you eat every day? Hashish? Your prophet, obviously, he was high. This cannot be cocaine. This is a very bad stuff. Like, this is street stuff, will make him go really left. And your prophet was not even, he don't even know how to count his fingers now. But guys, be honest with me. Don't you like the answer of Zakir Naik, which I made like in a second? Do you see how I come with the answer? But this is supposedly a Zakir Naik, you know. I can be very good at writing fiction stories. I can be a prophet like Muhammad, actually. Unbelievable. The God who gave me a brain is the same God who gave you the brain, Abdul? I don't want to be an atheist. I don't want to be an atheist. I want to stay believe that he is the same God. But for some reason, you don't want to use it. All right. CP is surely a kid that he more reason why he cannot be kebakul. My friend, I am just that you know, I am 6 years old, kid. And did I say 6 years old, kid? Uh-oh. The prophet, he will get excited now. In his grave. For he have a very, very unique, passionate, and desire for little children's. Don't talk about kids. Not in the front of your prophet. Be careful. If you're a prophet, he come home to visit you one day, and he says to you, I want to be Santa Claus. Don't let your daughter ever sit in his lap. Dangerous. Wee, wee, wee. This guy, he liked them. Very much. Not only that, just to show you how evil Muhammad is. The man he was married and his name, Jabir. And Jabir, he married, he want to go home. He like his wife. He's happy with it, with her. So Muhammad was walking behind him, and he said to Jabir, hey, Jabir, why you are a rush? Huh? As you see, this is reported tons of times. This is a very sahih hadith. He said to him, why you are walking quickly? Why you are going so quickly? Jabir, he said, well, I am newly married. Muhammad, he said, did you marry a woman? Her private part is still in the wax, or it is used. What the heck? What a question. What's your business? When you ask a man if he married a previously married woman or a child who is a virgin, why you are asking about, because this is about the vagina. You know, who cares if she is previously married or not? What's your business? She's his wife. Why you are putting your nose in the vagina of the wife to know what is the situation? Is it still brand new or it's been used? The guy, he said, well, she is previously married. The prophet said, why? 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 Why, man? Why? Why? The prophet, why what? Why you do that? About what? Why you marry a woman she is previously married, you idiot? Why you don't marry a young child? Who you can play with her, and she could play with you. What the heck? Play with her, play with you? So the prophet here is playing the devil. The guy is happily married, and he's trying to tempt him to leave the woman who is his wife, and he like her, and seek a child to sleep with. Do you see the devil voice? What's your business? The man is happily married with his wife. Why you are tempting him to leave her and find a little girl. And what is the target? Not to establish a family. Not because he spoke about something wise. So she might play with you and you play with her. This is God, Prophet. This is nothing but a scam. Do you see it? How in the world Muhammad can be a prophet of God? A Muslim saying to us, you Christians bow to God that send you to be slaughtered. My friend, I will prefer to be slaughtered, not to believe in a God of penises. I hope you will enjoy the penis which Allah will give you. Go and watch my previous videos a few days ago, where all the Muslims, they call me, including the Moroccan guy, they agree that in the heaven they have sex with their mother, their sister, their daughter. This is what you are promising me. You will be white, you will be 30 meters tall, your penis will be endless, and your wife, she will be the whore of the town. Because the Quran says whatever you wish. Anyone he wish your wife, he will take her. He will take a ride. Do we have any Muslim have the courage? Anyone? Don't talk about imbalance, my friend. You're a prophet, they broke his eight in the front. And Allah did not send him the ambulance. I don't know even how Muhammad was able to recite the Quran, because this has happened to him since the beginning of his start saying he's a prophet. How somebody have no teeth can say just try it. Ask your grandfather who lost his teeth to recite the Quran, and you tell me how funny it's going to be. You have teeth and you cannot recite it, so imagine without teeth. Boko Haram are following your prophet. Your prophet he raped, your prophet he killed, your prophet he kidnapped, your prophet accused even by the Muslims that he stole an underwear. And Allah, he made a chapter about it. And by the way, until now the underwear is not found, it's missing. So in case you found the underwear which the prophet he took, please call the FBI. Imagine if you can't find that underwear and you say it in auction. The Christian fascinating? Yeah, we fascinate, my friend. We are the one who fascinate, right? Let me show you your prophet fascinating legally, officially. This is your prophet fascinating. The prophet continued for such and such a period, imagining that he have bang, 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 bing, bong, boom, boom, bam, ba, bang, bang, bing, bong, bing, bong, bing, bong, bam, ba. But in fact, he did not. What happened? What happened? The prophet, he was imagining himself having doing boom, boom. But the prophet was not doing boom, boom. By the way, when the prophet, he imagined himself doing boom, boom with his wife. But it turned to be, he is not doing it with his wives. He was doing it with who? Boom, 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 boom. Are you there, Muslims? This is the guy you follow. He lost his mind. I am the one who need the doctor. Asani, he said, I need the doctor. Somebody told you I imagine myself having sex, but in fact I'm not. Hey, Prophet, Prophet, what are you doing, Prophet? Prophet, leave the pillow. Prophet, leave the goat. This is the goat. This, but Prophet, don't do that. This is a goat. Oh, sorry, sorry. I thought this is my wife. I was imagining that this is my wife. Prophet, please, Prophet, wake up. Your eyes was open, but you were doing something. It's haram. You were holding the goat but I thought I was doing it to my wife. Prophet, no, you were not. It was the goat. And yesterday it was the pillow. That's why the pillow is dirty. You have a prophet who is awake, not asleep. But yet he imagined himself having sex. No wonder his wife never have babies. Anyway, guys, we have enough for today. Don't forget to download the videos, please, and share it with your friends. We are here for how many hours now? 6 hours? How many hours? Unbelievable. 4 or 5? Hey, no, I will not take no more calls, please. I'm done talking for today. Sorry, I apologize. Too much talk. Don't forget to download these videos, share it around, especially if you are from Nigeria. And if you are from Nigeria, I challenge this guy. His name is Asani Latif, brother Latif. I have a special request for you. I want you to download this video and post it in your Facebook. I challenge you. If you are really a man, you will do that. What do you think, guys? If he is really a man, he will download the video and paste it in Facebook because he was victorious as all the Muslims. I never spoke to a Muslim he lose. Never. It's impossible. They always win. Always. They don't lose. Anyway, my friend, I want to say thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you all. And I forgive you, Asani, for lying about you knowing Arabic and about knowing your religion and about accusing your God, saying that he lied when he said the Nasara, they worship Allah and look like you and your ustaz is the same, graduate from the same school, which is the school of Zakir Naik. Nobody. Brothers and sisters. So we are happy to have you all, and thank you for your support. Thank you for being here. Thank you for downloading the videos. And I challenge the Muslims again to download my videos and paste in your channel, especially your call to me. Especially as it is, don't play games with it. Don't edit so everybody will laugh. So thank you. May the Lord bless you. And until we see you soon again, Christ is Lord, Islam nothing but a scam, and see you soon. Bye-bye.